I've known I was a wolf since a really young age. Well, I had a big following because I usually go to the conventions and I meet a lot of people. And I had got accused of killing and beheading a dog. I did behead him. I didn't kill him. He was my friend. His name was Shadow.
Well, you see, she didn't kill him. She just cut his head off, which is, I think, what most of us think of when we picture a wolf in our mind, capable of using sharp instruments in anger and beheading other animals which are challenging their dominance. Well, that or the nonstop raping that wolves are well known for. It's very, very problematic. I don't know if Tumblr can handle having wolves on their website. These violent rapists are a danger to everyone, especially dogs, apparently, in this case. Welcome, one and all, to the sixth installment of Tumblrisms. We're going to be taking a look at Otherkin as we journey through the land of insanity, otherwise known as Tumblr. There's no real way to get around this, but buckle up, because this is going to be one hell of a fucking episode. The sheer amount of insanity in this one particular group is off the fucking charts. And I've looked at some crazy shit before, but Otherkin really takes the cake when it comes to batshit raving lunacy. So I think it's gonna be fun. But you know, we need to pin down what that definition is, because we're shitlords. You need to remember that. We are privileged shitlords, and we need to understand how these snowflakes think. We've got to get their terminology down. Because when you go into Tumblr and when you're looking at Otherkin, you're gonna start to see all sorts of weird shit. And I think one of the first things, even before we go and look up the definition of Otherkin, we probably need to make a distinction between what is a furry and what is an Otherkin. Well, it just so happens that I've used my immense artistic skills, which I'm well known for, to put together this nice little infograph that I think will help to highlight the major difference between what a furry is and what an Otherkin is. A furry is a human pretending to be a wolf. An Otherkin is a wolf pretending to be a human. Let me see if I can clarify it a little bit more. A furry smells like death because they've been in that suit for 5 days at a convention, and the internal temperature in that motherfucker is equal to the same temperature your oven would be at if you wanted to cook a pizza. An Otherkin drags their ass on the ground rather than using toilet paper. A furry will drink far too much alcohol and then nearly die of dehydration when they yiff themselves into a coma in the hotel room later that night. An Otherkin will piss on their mother's azalea bushes so the other dogs in the neighborhood know who the fucking alpha male is. A furry will terrify children in a costume they've made that looks like something that's been birthed from a nightmare into the real world. An Otherkin will growl at ground beef in the market because they think that's what hunting is. So now that we know that critical difference between a furry and an Otherkin, let's pop on by valhallenbadger.tumblr.com to get a better idea of just what this Otherkin community is really all about. So, just who is Valhallen Badger? Well, this is their About Me section. Hello, you can call me Elliot. I identify as androgynine, and my pronouns are Z, Zir, Zers, and Zerself. I'm pansexual and panromantic. I'm a 20-year-old college student majoring in geology. I love to draw and sculpt. I'm a spiritual polytherian, and my theriotypes are as follows. American badger. Not one of those commie Russian motherfuckers. It's an American badger. I tend to feel this one most strongly, thus my URL. I also identify as a hurrah bat, and as a black-tailed jackrabbit. In addition, I identify as being cat-hearted, deer-hearted, and fiction-hearted, with Thoruku Tasaki from the book Colorless Teruku Hizaki and His Years of Pilgrimage. I'm neurodivergent. I have major depressive disorder, MDD, general anxiety disorder, GAD, agoraphobia, and avoidant personality disorder, AVPD. In addition, I have issues with paranoia, some delusions induced by anxiety, and a severe problem with maladaptive daydreaming. So now, for some less serious information about me. I enjoy metal, punk, and folk music most of all. I'm always open to music suggestions that fall outside of these genres, however, especially if it's cool experimental music. I like drawing and crafting. I may post some of my creations occasionally. I am interested in taxidermy and bone collecting. Wow. I also enjoy collecting rocks and mineral samples. I'm a pagan and an animist. Oh, I'm Mod Badger at Kin Experiences. Holy shit. This is like reading John Wayne Gacy's fucking journal from when he's 10. You know what's going to happen. You can't read this and not know what's going to happen. Hi, I'm completely insane and think I'm a badger. By the way, I'm really interested in collecting bones. What are you stepping in my van? Let's go for a drive. Holy fucking hell. So now that we know a little bit more about the person that wrote this, let's find out about otherkinanity. Things that people need to realize about otherkinanity. I don't know how to pronounce that. Things that people need to realize about otherkinanity. Seriously, people both inside and outside the community need to get it through their heads that otherkin means to identify as non-human. Identifying with something non-human is being other-hearted. The two are not the same. A kin type is not a fursona. Someone can make their fursona after their kin type or realize they actually are kin to the creature chosen as their fursona, but the two are not equivalent by definition. Otherkinanity is not exclusively a spiritual belief. Many otherkin identify as such for psychological reasons. Otherkinanity is not a gender identity. We are not appropriating transgender struggles. Some otherkin are transgender. A fair amount are, in fact. Being one doesn't mean one cannot be the other. They are different types of identities. Stop erasing the gender identities of trans otherkin and stop using the existence of otherkin to invalidate trans people's identities. Your transphobia is disgusting and blatantly obvious. Some otherkin experience species dysphoria, which means they have a strong disconnect with their human body. Trans otherkin have found similarities between species dysphoria and their gender dysphoria if they have it, and so the two get discussed. They are not the same, but they can be comparable. Otherkin don't think it's cultural appropriation to wear wolf ears, or that it's oppression to have houseplants, or something ridiculous like that. Stop falling for obvious trolls. Otherkinity is not a mental illness by definition. Some may identify as such due to reasons derived from trauma or illness, but it isn't in and of itself a mental illness. In fact, a large majority of us who are mentally ill, in addition to being otherkin, have confided our identity to mental health professionals who think it's a healthy identity to have. Stop yelling at us to get help. Your ableism is not appreciated by anyone. I'm sure there are other important things out there that should be added to the list, but this is all my brain is coming up with for the nonce. Well, you know, I'm going to have to agree. I don't think wearing wolf ears is cultural appropriation. I'm fairly certain wolves aren't going to mind. But now we have a better picture of insanity. So going forward, we're going to have a better idea of what we're dealing with, because there are all sorts of kin types. You might have heard them discuss that, or Therians. Now, there's a difference between those two, but I can't be fucking bothered to learn it. I can only handle so much crazy in one sitting. And if you're looking for me to go into all of this, that's not going to happen. I'm just dealing with kin types. So what's a kin type? Well, you'll find that other kin use kin as a suffix for pretty much anything. You can be a plant kin, you can be a dragon kin, you can be a fiction kin, you can be a kin if you wanted to be, which would be even more insane. I don't know if that exists yet, but by the end of this video or by the time people watch it, I'm sure it's fucking going to exist. Welcome to Tumblr, where anything can be real, because fuck you, that's why. Now, you may be saying, Jim, come on, there's got to be a limit. But you'd be wrong, as seen in the post by Paranoid Raindrops. Please like or reblog this if you are weatherkin, divinekin of any kind, demonkin, void spacekin, just want to be friends with this lonely rain cloud. I have to start over from nothing, and I would very much enjoy the opportunity to follow you and have new people in my life. And then it's hashtagged otherkin, we are the kin, divinekin, demonkin, voidkin, spacekin, and raindropkin. That's right. There are people out there that are weatherkin. Apparently, Doppler radar is such hot shit that people identify as it. I know that when I feel a rainstorm coming, I want to find a weatherman and have him hold me tenderly. So now that we have a better idea of just what an otherkin is, let's go out and meet the community. And what better place to start than here? Small deer boy explores the forest of his mind. Hashtag, I'm actually a stag. Selfie. Agender. Demi boy. They, them, he, him, deerkin, otherkin, antlers, reblog my selfie if you love me, panromantic, demisexual. So just what are we going to find at castlebeyondthegoblincity.tumblr.com? Well, the Goblin King. The years have not been kind to David Bowie. My name is Imber. I'm a 16-year-old nature-worshipping agender demiboy. I prefer neutral pronouns, but I'm also fine with male. Part-time gentle forest creature. Part-time ferocious beast, polykin wolf deer dragon, amateur cosplayer and aspiring furry, hardcore feminist, Illinois, I draw, write, sing, act, and play the ukulele, single, I take my not safe for work, I always pick hugs over drugs, And then there's the Instagram and Etsy accounts they use. So just to sum up, it's a 16-year-old nature-worshipping feminist, demi-boy, who's single right now. So any ladies out there, got you covered. So let's see what the Goblin King has to say. This is from April 4th, 2015. Some yuppie dude bro. Pop music has destroyed my hope for humanity. Me? Really? Not racism? Not sexism? Not the rampant discrimination of the human race by the cishet male white hierarchy? Not war? Not genocide? Not the fact that we're killing our planet? Some yuppie dude bro. Nah, I don't give a shit about that. What really grinds my gears is seeing young girls listening to music and having fun. Well, I think we found a winner here. Let's delve a little deeper. Now, this next post is pretty long, but I think it gives you an idea of just who the Goblin King is. So let's find out a little bit more about our Deerkin. Day 1. I cried so hard that it scared my father. He spent the night outside my bedroom door just to make sure I didn't stop breathing like a newborn in her crib the first week. Day 2. I went to work and I cried in the bathroom. Day 3. I believe I was cured. Now I think my mind was playing a cruel joke on me. Day 4. I told you I miss you, and you replied with, thank you. Day 5. I saw a picture of you on Instagram, and it lit my throat on fire, so I burned your love letters over the flame. Day 6. I smoked weed with a boy on his back porch, and he asked questions you were afraid to. But still, I couldn't kiss him on his couch. Day 7. I couldn't sleep because I kept dreaming of you kissing other girls on your couch. Day 8. I gave you all of your stuff back, and you thought I looked like a warrior, but really, I went home and cried an entire ocean into existence. Day 9. I laughed without you. Day 10. I kept finding excuses to text you, and you kept ignoring me. Day 11. I cried until my stomach heaved itself up, and I slept next to the toilet in case those nasty dreams came again. Day 12. Since when is heartbroken so goddamn romantic? There's nothing pretty about losing feelings in my knuckles after squeezing my hand so tight to keep from texting you. Day 13. I could never squeeze them tight enough. I could never imagine that you would be so good at letting me fade. Day 14. The doubt makes my spine feel less like vertebrae and more like giant icicles. You never loved me. Day 15. I found out you had replaced me and it flicked at my bruises, but my ribs didn't break. Day 16. I told everyone about you, and they said you were stupid for leaving. But I think you were stupid for staying the first time you sliced my heart on the side of the road. Day 17. I didn't think about you for an entire night because I was drunk in bed with someone else. Day 18. What color are your eyes? How big are your hands? Where was that freckle on your face I used to look at while you slept? Day 19. Sometimes all I feel in my chest is my heart trying to break out of its cage. I think it's tired of everything I have put it through. Day 20. I'm sorry I couldn't ignore your birthday. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Day 21. This was a shitty poem about a shitty person, but I don't think of you so much anymore. I don't think of you so much anymore. Life is hard for a deer. Well, I cry every time. Well, I don't know about you, but I cry every time. Who knew that deers had such emotionally traumatic lives? Apparently, Tumblr is the number one website for fucking creatures in the forest. You know, Twitter's got to step up its game. All it's got are those birds. But if you've got four legs, if you're a quadruped, Tumblr is where it's at. That's where all the forest creatures go to tell you about their heartbreak and the sorrows of their lives. Like that one time the tree bark just didn't cut off right. Or how good that grass was yesterday. Or taking a shit next to that bush. Well, with all these struggles and hardships in life, like being a deer who happens to be a feminist, or a badger that wants to collect human bones, if there was only a place where Otherkin could go to release that emotional weight and to just lay it all out there. Oh, well, hey, what do you know there is? It's confessions.tumblr.com, a Tumblr blog set up to allow Otherkin to anonymously vent about their day-to-day frustration. So why don't we take a look at a few and get a better understanding of just the kind of traumas that the Otherkin deal with on a daily basis. Anonymous posts on the 4th of April. Even though everything I feel tells me I'm a bearkin, I don't want to be a bear. I don't particularly like bears. I just feel like I am one. Well, at least I know where to find the answer when somebody asks, does crazy shit in the woods? Anonymous posts on the 2nd of April. I'm slightly irritated at fictionkin in general. I don't hate anyone. I don't have the desire to tell people how to identify. It just seems like fictionkin are a bit less legit than someone who is a cat, dog, or dragonkin. Sorry, I need to reread that because my mind melted a little bit. It just seems like fictionkin are a bit less legit than someone who is a cat, dog, or dragonkin. I just don't get it. How do you live your life as a character that isn't real, or could die in the series? I think it's just an infatuation with a series rather than an actual identity. Come on. Come on. If irony had a physical weight to it, you could package this post up into a bag and bludgeon people to death with it. It's almost like watching somebody who's on the cusp of self-awareness, but they haven't made that final step over the line just yet. Anonymous posts on the 1st of April. I'm Dragonkin, and I get to travel a lot for work, but I hate flying an airplane so much. Being forced to sit straight up while enclosed in a tiny plane and not being able to stretch my wings out and fly myself makes me feel so sick and dizzy each flight. I wonder how many Dragonkin are base jumpers. Probably not a lot. Or probably not a lot that ever make it to the second jump. The ripcord's there for a reason, champ. Those wings aren't going to glide your ass to the ground just as safely as you might think they are. Just saying, pack a parachute, asshole. Anonymous posts on the 30th of March. I think identifying as a factkin is extremely disrespectful. Being factkin of a dead person does not make it better. You are disrespecting real people and disrespecting the memory of those past. It's ableist to claim you or someone else, as they would definitely trigger disassociative episodes, and racist to ID as factkin of someone of another race than you. Sincerely, it is disrespectful all around. You see, there's a line you don't cross. If you want to be a deer, go right ahead, but don't you dare say you're Benjamin Franklin. That's a step too far. Anonymous posts on the 27th of March. I'm Demonkin, but a peaceful and helpful demon, so I don't get along with some of the other Demonkin on Tumblr, which sucks. I'm really lonely. Plus, it's kind of scary because they tell me I should try and hang around Angelkin instead, most of which I'm anxious of. Old habits die hard. I just wish there were more demons like me. So even in the land of special snowflakes, this particular Demon King is a special snowflake. You'd think the fires of hell would melt him, but no, apparently not. He's just a nice guy all around. I wasn't spitting pea soup at the priest because I wanted to spook him. I just was trying to give him a pleasant meal. I was thinking of his health. He needs to eat healthier. Anonymous posts on the 26th of March. I'm a deer Therian, and I really wish I could find a herd. It's called hunting. Good luck. Anonymous posts on the 25th of March. As a deerkin, it's very pleasing to hang out deep in the woods where everything is quiet, especially eating berries and reading a book, maybe. I get very depressed in the winter because it's too cold for me to do this. You poor bastard. Unable to eat berries and read books like every other deer out there. I feel your pain. Anonymous posts on the 17th of March. I'm a dollkin, feeling astral horns, and I don't know why. Perhaps it's because you're fucking crazy. Look into that. I don't know. It's a little tip from me. Maybe you're just completely insane. Anonymous posts on the 14th of March. I'm birdkin. When I was little, I always ran with closed eyes and spread my arms out. Tried to jump as far and as high as I could and imagined I would fly. I still do it when no one is watching. It feels so natural not to feel the ground beneath me. That is until the moment my face connects with the fucking pavement and I get sent to the hospital with a concussion. Yeah, I bet you do it when no one's watching. Because you look insane. What the fuck are you talking about? You're right. Jesus. There are people like this. Anonymous posts on the 8th of March. I'm Monsterkin, and sometimes I make small growling noises, and I feel special when my friends call it cute. God, it's almost like... Yeah, hear me out on this. I know it's crazy. It's almost like you're doing this for attention. That's weird, huh? Like, maybe you're not really a Monsterkin, and you just want people to pay attention to you? I know, I'm probably way off. You keep doing what you're doing, hiding under beds and grabbing little kids' feet when they pop out to go take a pee in the middle of the night, or whatever the fuck it is you do. Anonymous posts on the 27th of February. When I walk past the raw meat aisle in stores, I get hungry. The meat just looks so tasty and chewy, and I drool imagining the taste and texture in my mouth. I can't tell if I'm Demonkin or Wolfkin, or something like that. All I know is that I want to eat raw meat. Can you picture this? A, let's say, 20-year-old morbidly obese man in a wolf costume, drooling at the mouth as he stares at ground beef in the meat aisle of his store, as children run screaming because he's furiously masturbating, because that's what wolves do. Don't argue with me on this. I know about this. I've read enough Tumblr to know this. They behead dogs. and they masturbate in the meat aisle at stores. It's just part of what wolves naturally do. Stop being ableist, you fucking shitlords. Don't judge them. They're special. You need to respect that. You know, there was a time, and it wasn't that long ago, and for some circles it still exists, where furries were the worst thing on the internet. It seemed like every week you had another story of another Tumbles the Stare Dragon. And for anybody who doesn't know who Tumbles is, feel free to go check out the Dramatica article. It's fucking eye-opening. But every week, it seemed like there was something like that. They were obnoxious. They were everywhere. They were constantly pushing their dumb shit everywhere. Their art was everywhere. And the people that were in the community were seen to be freaks. But something happened over the last 7 years. 7 or 8 years. Now, don't get me wrong. They're still freaks. But they're freaks with a better image. Now, part of that is because of people like, I don't know, Uncle Kage.
I have often said that we are our own worst enemy. Because of the early days of furry fandom, the image that was put forth to the world at large was not perhaps the most positive image that could have existed. I've been trying to fight that ever since.
And what he says is right. They are their own worst enemy. You've got to take back control and rein it in a little bit. Now, is that possible with Otherkin? Can Otherkin rein it back in? Because when you go through Tumblr, when you're looking at this, it is insanity. Pure insanity. You have people that believe that they are everything that could possibly exist. They are dead people. They are living people. They are fictional characters. They are dragons and lizards. They're wolves. They're plants. They're fairies and fae, they're demons and gods. They are convinced of it. You throw in a little sprinkling of mental illness and it really takes off. It's like the Headmates thing, where you're facilitating, you're helping along crazy people to be even crazier by letting them buy into this bullshit, by not having a division, a line that says, hey, it's play pretend. We're not being real here. It's hard to look through this and to go through the tags, and there are so many Tumblrs about Otherkins out there. And by the way, I saw this one. Please, God. Please make this a thing. Because this is so dumb on its own that it just deserves to exist. I was really disappointed that there weren't more of these. Because that would have been the whole fucking video. If I could have got this, this should be a fucking thing. But when you break it down to its brass tacks, what are you looking at? Well, you saw in those confessions, right, these anonymous posters, almost all of them repeat the same thing. And if you go and look at that Tumblr, you're going to see what I'm talking about. It's people that want attention. They want to feel special. This has become a badge of honor in our current society. The more diverse, the more unique you are, the more worth you have. You can't just be average or ordinary or mundane. You can't just be a human being. You have to be a demigod, a deerkin. You have to be the system mate of a fucking head star and all this other crazy bullshit, because then you can tack it up on your little Tumblr blog and more people will pay attention. And it's not even enough anymore that there are all these bizarre things, that these other kins are all these different forms of nutty. They have to fight amongst themselves who's more unique. Go look at that confession page. It's mind-boggling how many of them will say, I'm just the same as this other person, but I'm a little bit different, and oh, woe is me, how lonely I am. Will you come and look at my blog and cry me a fucking river? What the hell happened to the internet? I mean, there, in my mind, after going through this, there's a sharp line between furry and otherkin. Furries are fun to laugh at, but I don't think they're crazy. Otherkin is a completely different thing. It's attention whoring at a level that just is, it's mind-blowing. It's boggling, really, when you look at it. So really, at the end of the day, it looks like the otherkin community is broken down into a couple of different groups. You've got one group that are people that are desperate for attention, and they will make themselves unique in any way they can to get that attention. It's just a way of drawing people to them. The other group are legitimately crazy people that have been drug along for the ride by these attention-whoring assholes.
We live tillsammans. We sit in soffan och ibland gosar jag på henne och ibland så brottas vi. Det är oftast mest vanliga tråkiga vardagsgrejer.
You know, I was looking over some things related to other kins, just having a laugh, and I found some documentaries about other kins, so we're going to watch some of that. But have you ever heard of mental shifting? Now, I did a video on other kins, but I never heard of mental shifting until recently. That's where retarded teenagers that think they're actual wolves transform for you on camera. Have you ever wanted to see a fat girl drop to her knees and start barking like a dog? Have you ever wanted to see an autistic guy shove a tail up his ass and start rolling on his back and playing with yarn? That's what a mental shift is. And I found a whole fucking bunch of mental shifting. And it's almost too good not to pay attention to. So I thought we'd have some fun. And these aren't furries. There's a difference between an otherkin and a furry. Otherkins aren't as perverse, but they're two times as insane. So it's like a trade-off. They're not out there fucking the family dog. They're trying to live a life of the family dog. There's so many mental shifting videos. I don't understand how this is a thing. They're all young. It's all like teenagers doing it. At first I thought maybe this is like a joke. Maybe this is a group of people that got together and wanted to have a laugh, but no. No, they're fucking serious about it. So I'll get that all queued up and go, you know, next otherkin day today. Also, just as an aside before I get to it, Nick Riccata murdered a man on stream two nights ago. If you get a chance to watch this, I'm not going to play it on stream and commentate over it. It's entertaining enough on its own. But he fucking slaughtered a retard in front of a massive audience. A Wikipedia lawyer arguing with an actual lawyer about the law. Really highly entertaining. The dude was literally drinking soy, which is... he's like he wanted to make the stereotype real. I don't know what to tell you. But maybe check that out if you get a chance. Highly entertaining shit. All right, let me get the Therian. Oh, they love that word. They like to use new terms. Can't call ourselves otherkins. People are making fun of that too much. We're Therians now. Oh, there's I've got five of them. Like, I don't want to spoil it. It's a fat girl. It's a fat girl with a dog collar barking like a dog. There's so many things that are wrong about this. I don't know why she would do this to herself, but okay. All right, internet. You go ahead and be insane. I'm not going to tell you otherwise. All right, let's pop the chat out here. Get everything nice and set up. By the way, if the stream dies on you, you know, it's streamy. Just hit F5 to refresh. Sound quality cuts out. Again, F5 to refresh. There's not a lot I can do on my end. I'm streaming at a relatively... low-end bit rate. We're not going above like 720p. I've got a fairly solid internet connection. There's not a lot I can do about it. I'm sorry. All right. Let us get this all lined up. Get this video front and center. I don't understand what compels teenagers to do things like this. They have to know that eventually they're going to grow up and it's never going to go away. Like, this fat girl has to know that some point in her life, she's going to be like 5 years into the future and people are going to be like, holy shit, whatever your name is, what the fuck were you thinking? All right, let's jump into the world of Therian, which is another term for otherkin. That's the special term they have for themselves. Show us what mental shifting is all about. Jesus Christ. Okay. I think we're about ready here. Let's jump into some good old retardation. Say hi to yourself, chat. Remember, don't let Kurt Eichenwald ruin this for us. You've got to teach that motherfucker a lesson. Lots of flashing GIFs so he doesn't come and harass us. I don't want his wife writing tersely worded tweets at us. Keep him away. All right, otherkin mental shift wolf. Yeah, I had to put the little thing. In case you get confused why this fat girl's going to bark at us, it's because she's turning into a wolf, okay? All right, let's watch this.
Not, there's no wrong or right way to mental shift, it's just how I prefer to mental shift.
Sorry.
and also how... No, sorry. And I don't...
Really deep philosophical lessons from the Therry and other Ken right now. There's no way to... There's no wrong way to mental shift. She's right. There's no wrong way to be crazy. You can be insane in any way you choose. Crazy is crazy. She's absolutely correct about that.
I don't have to do any other shifting to stop practicing, so let's get to it. Okay, so just give me a sec. My people have... If it takes too long, just pause the video and we'll edit it.
Yeah.
Here comes the magic, chat. Prepare yourselves. We've got a teen wolf on our hands, and she's going to transform magically before you. Ah, method acting. She needs to find the place deep in her soul where the wolf lives and call him forth from his den, located between her third and fourth gunt. Heavy breathing, can you hear it? She's getting into the act. I am the were- Look at this shit! Not a scrap of self-awareness. She's fucking growling! Humane Society, I'd like to report a loose animal. It's a very obese dog. It's wearing children's clothing. I don't know what the hell's going on. Get off the furniture. You're not allowed up there. You're a wolf. That's for people. You sit on the ground. This is really amazing acting, by the way. Can you tell I'm a wolf? I slap my paws down. This is the sound she makes when she goes to a buffet with her family. Oh fuck, I'm getting scared, guys. Now, do you think this lovely young lady, do you think she ever wonders why nobody invites her to parties? Do you think she spends her evenings writing in her diary, why don't any of the other children like me? Why won't they invite me to their birthday parties and slumber parties? Is it because I shove a tail up my ass and wear a dog collar and bark at them? No, that couldn't be it. It must be because I'm too beautiful. They're just jealous. You're a wolf, not a cat. You don't hate the water, idiot. Maybe read a book about the thing you're pretending to be. She's out of breath, Chad. Is that what you said? Yeah. Energy level's depleted. Time to transform back into a human and eat 10 cupcakes. Oh, I guess the wolf, it's over.
Okay, guys, thanks. That was me mental shifting, and I hope you enjoyed. Please like, subscribe, and all that stuff.
Well, you don't have to tell me twice. Like, thank you very much for teaching me how to mental shift. I really enjoyed that. I really enjoyed the lesson on how to do that. And no, that's not a one-off. They're all insane. So let's go look at some more mental shifting. Oh, I don't understand why this is a thing. And it's all teenagers. They all start barking. What the fuck?
Hello, people. Today, I am going to be trying to do a shift. Not sure how well this is going to...
Can you hear that shit looping in the background? How much do her parents hate her? Just wolves and dogs howling. She has it on a fucking loop on her stereo. Is that Moon Man? You see, this looks like a possum that has been nailed to a rock, which is the first sign she needs to see a therapist. And I'm fucking fairly certain that's Moon Man. I don't know what is going on with her.
Turn out, it's not what you're gonna expect. I'm probably going to not actually turn into a wolf. I'm just gonna act very wolf-like, most likely. We'll see what happens. And if I sound a little sick, it's because I have a flu. Plus an ear infection, so yeah, not fun.
I swear to God, if I were her father, I would kick that fucking door open and I would throw the stereo out the window. I bet she sits in there for hours on hours on hours listening to animals howl. She's clearly very deeply into it, given all the plushies and the disturbing art of possums fucking nailed to rocks on her wall.
As you can hear, I also have Wolf howling in the background. Why is this here? Sorry.
Oh, we have another tale. Okay, let me back that up a little bit, just in case you missed it. Of course, it's another poor innocent child that stapled a tail onto her ass to really live the life of a wolf. I mean, social media is a thing, right? I thought teenage girls were the most self-conscious about their image. Could you imagine her classmates stumbling on this? She wouldn't survive a day in junior high if they found a video of her snarling like a fucking dog with a tail stapled on her ass. I love how all their transformations, too, are the same thing. They get down on all fours and kind of just slap at the ground and wiggle back and forth. And then they a-woo, really loudly, like 4 or 5 times, snarl a couple times, and then energy levels depleted. Time to turn back into a human. Okay, real talk chat. Imagine you're a parent and you don't know anything about your crazy daughter being insane. And you walk into her room at this exact moment as she's squatting on the floor, looking like she's shitting a tail out, with dogs howling in the background and fucking possums nailed to rocks on the wall. And she's snarling and circling about like she's gonna urinate and mark her territory. How quickly do you call the police? How quickly do you call men in white coats to come take her away? Oh, holy shit! Our little wolf is athletic. What, did she fucking hop? What was that? I want to see one of these videos where the parents walk into the room. That has to be the completion of it. There's no way to sensibly explain what she's doing. I need to hear her mother's reaction. She's playing with the stuffed animals like they're dog toys. She's fucking insane. Oh. Oh, this one's far more committed. She's far more committed to her method acting than the fat one was. She's going the full 9 yards at this. She's hopping around like a fucking handicapped wolf frolicking in the woods, jumping on furniture, I guess, chewing up stuffed animals because that's what wolves do.
Alright, that was me shifting. I do not know what happened.
I do. Here's what happened. You were raised by a single parent, and you don't have very many friends. So you act out in crazy ways so somebody, anybody at all on the planet Earth will pay attention to you. That's what happened here today. This is a cry for help. You videotaped a cry for help and put it on the internet. And we see it. We see your cry for help, and we feel badly for you. Now stop sticking tails up your ass and chewing on stuffed animals. You look like an idiot.
So please leave a like, share with your friends, and subscribe. I'm out of breath.
I bet you are. That was a very active play routine. You're chewing on all the stuffed animals. I bet you're out of breath. Oh, it's a very busy day for you. Okay, let's see. Let's find another glorious... Oh, there's so many of these. It's fucking ridiculous. I never saw this shit before, and now it's everywhere. I don't understand what the fuck is going on. Okay, here we go. I really want to learn the ins and outs of this. I'm sure you do too, chat. I mean, if I could become a wolf by mental shifting, why wouldn't I do it? Never have to go out and buy groceries. I could just hunt squirrels for sustenance. Never have to worry about security. Who needs a gun when I can bare my fangs at attackers? It comes in useful in a lot of ways. Who needs toilets? I can just piss on trees. The life of a wolf sounds great. So I need to know how to mental shift into one so I can live that life effectively.
Being a Therian can get weird at times. Because sometimes you're just really, really sorry. When you are like, we really, really want to shift. Or we shift randomly. But...
Okay. They shift randomly. So not only are they crazy little fuckers, they do this publicly for attention. Imagine sitting next to this. And again, this is, 10-1, they've got a tail. This is another dog collar wearer. Looks like Pat from an SNL sketch. Just imagine sitting next to them, and they suddenly start barking at you. Sorry, couldn't handle myself. It was a Therian mental shift.
Today I could control it, and then I decided to... let it all out right now. I'm gonna try not to bump my head on the ceiling though. Cause, as you can see, the ceiling is like that. I have my beautiful tail on.
No, Chad, I don't think you can kill a Therian. I don't think you can kill them with a silver bullet. You need a lithium bullet. Or maybe a Thorazine bullet. That's the kind of bullet you need to be loading up to deal with this. Don't shake your fucking ass tail at me, you bizarre genderless thing. Oh, they're doing the chew toy thing too. I'm pretty sure wild wolves don't play with chew toys. I think you're thinking of domesticated dogs, idiot. Now, will it a woo for us? Are we going to get a little bit of roughing? Come on, bark for me, crazy. I know you want to do it. This is the laziest fucking mental shift I've ever seen. Oh, there we go. Awoo! Come on, do it. You know, awoo! There you go. Do it. Get it out of you. Look at this. It's laying on its back. totally insane. This person is mentally handicapped, and I love it. I love this mental shifting shit. What a fucking clusterfuck.
And that was cringy as fuck, yeah.
They have a little bit of the little self-awareness kicked in at the end there. I think they realized, wait a minute, what am I doing? What in the fuck am I doing on the internet? Now they have they have some other videos. This particular Therian does, like transgender problems. That's one of theirs. Starter fursuit for sale. My new fursuit badge. There's a fidget spinner video. You know what? I'm just going to show it to you because you're probably not going to believe that this is actually real. That one person could check off all the boxes like this. So let's take a look. This is their YouTube channel. There's the transgender problem video. A fursuit dance. My new fursuit badge. Fursuit for sale. Jasper the Jackal. The reference sheet, of course. We need that. Fidget spinners. It's just every... Oh, selling fursuit parts. You got to chop it up. Maybe make a little bit of money. Extra money on the aftermarket. I think... what is this? This looks... Is that a dog head? We have to watch some of these. I'm sorry. I haven't prepared to watch all of these, but...
Since you guys say no! I hate young furs...
Oh, that is nightmare fuel. That is not an attractive fursuit head. That looks like the sort of shit you would see staring out of your closet at midnight after you drink too much whiskey and you piss yourself in fear and try to dial 911 before the heart attack takes you. It looks like a demon. It looks like a demon dog.
I want to make a video and tell you that I just don't agree with it.
All right, hey, pro tip for videos. In case this insane person ever watches this stream. Maybe if you're trying to make a really deep point to whatever crazy community you're a part of, don't wear a mascot head. That's maybe a starting place? Let's not put on mascot heads and have a deep conversation about the community. Because you look insane right now. And this looks awful. It looks like she shaved a cat's ass and glued it to foam. This looks like real hair. I don't know how, is that, it looks like a wig. This part here, I don't know if you can see my mouse, but the nose looks like an actual wig she stapled onto it. And dead cat hair has been used around the top of it. How many animals died for this?
Okay. I'm going to tell you why I don't agree with it. First of all, I see a lot of kids stealing art and stealing characters. Not good. Don't do that.
Yeah, OC original content. Do not steal. Don't take it. All right? Don't you take my original characters. I know you all saw Jackal, my fursona. Don't you fucking take it. That's mine. I own it. Copyright. Trademarked it.
I made another video about that. Go check it out. Okay. There's one big thing I'm going to come out and say. Is kids cause a lot of drama in the fandom.
Yeah, that's right. It's the kids' problems. Not the transgendered other kin that mental shifts and barks at the audience who made a fucking fursona fursuit mascot head by stapling a wig and dead cat parts together. Not that person. It's the kids that are the issue. It's fucking children. Let's go take a look at their original character that they don't want stolen. Oh, what an abomination. Is this what an animal looks like after you drop too much acid? One too many trips on DMT and this is what a jackal starts to look like? Is that how this works? Well, you know, those are great schematics. I'm sure the tailor will be able to figure out what insanity you want made into reality. Let's go watch... what is LPS? I don't even know what that is. Transgender problems.
Hey everyone, before we start this video, we just wanted to let you know that we're not making fun of any LGBTQ people. It's just a joke. Because Spencer, my cameraman, is actually transgender. So,
we're pretty much making fun of.
This person has a cameraman. We can clearly see you're filming this yourself. You're holding the camera, playing with. I don't even know what that is. You're playing with your toys on the floor, holding it. What do you mean you're cameraman? Are you Spencer? Is that a headmate?
Him. Roasting him. So, yeah. So, please don't get offended if you are transgender or... Girl, and so am I.
Holy fuck, this is reaching Game Dude levels. I haven't seen somebody play with toys and voice act dramas like this since the Game Dude. They're actually doing it! They're putting on a puppet show of furry drama for us, with their toy figurines.
When I'm older, I'm only 12 right now. But when I'm older, I am going to be turning myself into a girl instead of this horrible boy body. Hey man, I'd rather be a guy, honestly. Shut up, Spencer!
You shut the fuck up, Richard Spencer, with your ethno-stage shit! Can't you see that us furries just want to be girls? God, Spencer, what's your problem? Always talking about the white race. Alright, I just want to stick a tail up my ass and mental shift into a werewolf. Stop getting on my case, buddy.
Whatever. Ha. I'm Georgie. And Clips the Wolf makes fun of me. I don't like Clips the Wolf. Clips the Wolf is my friend.
You hear that, you fur fag? Clips the Wolf is Richard Spencer's friend. It's much more entertaining imagining that this is Richard Spencer that this crazy person is arguing with. Why can't I get into the ethno state, Richard? Is it because I decapitated a moose and wear its head? Is it, why you gotta discriminate, bro?
They don't. She makes fun of me. Clips is just a little choker, that's all. Okay?
You know, I think we might have stumbled into something really special. Really? We might have found something extra special here. Let's look through and see. I probably should have looked at more of the videos. My public fursuiting experience. Okay, that's probably going to be a fat lady kills herself? Is this a glimpse into the future?
I'm too fat. I have too much hard time losing weight. I'm so depressed. I'm gonna kill myself now. Goodbye, cruel world.
Okay, that little drama, right? This person is speaking through toys. All right, I give her, him, whatever. I give him a year before they do a front flip off a bridge. Like, there's some warning signs going up. I'm getting some flags coming up here. In fact, oh god, I might have been more right than I thought. All the videos stopped 1 year ago. All the videos stopped a year ago! There's no more videos! It's all going up, and then nothing. Just radio silence. Holy shit, they killed themselves. This was a cry for help nobody listened to, and now they're dead. And we're watching the only thing that will ever F in chat for our Therian bro. Oh, Richard Spencer, this is your fault. I blame Richard Spencer for this beautiful individual's death. They clearly did a backflip. Because of you, Rich. What are you doing? Adam's kin type. Oh, I need to know about Adam's kin type.
Hey everybody, I was just gonna make a video that I...
Oh, we're off to a good start. Really, really good start. Nice, I thought, where's your cameraman? Thought you had a transgender cameraman. I don't understand.
I'm sorry, my phone fell. Anyways, I've been meaning to make this video. Adam, I wanted him to do it because it's about him, but he is camera shy, so...
Alright, I'm going to throw this out right now. We're only just digging into this. Adam doesn't exist. This person is Adam. There is no cameraman. This is Adam. We're watching Adam right now. That toy of the fat lady killing herself? That was a puppet play cry for help? Oh God, this is going to get dark.
He didn't want to do it. So I'm going to just tell you. Okay, so he was telling me a few weeks ago, actually I think it was last month sometime, that he had a dream shift and he's not just a Therian, he's a other kin too.
Okay, so your imaginary headmate, Adam, had a dream shift and they're not just a Therian anymore. Now they're an other kin. I guess there's a difference I didn't know about. Let's get educated.
Like me. He only has one theriotype, and that's Chase. And we are the alphas of our pack, the Indigo Moon Pack.
They have a fucking pack. The Indigo Moon Pack. This is an alpha. All right, hey, chat, pay attention. This stud, super chat here, our werewolf, okay, little puppet player here, alpha. All right, bow down, you beta bitches. This is the leader of the pack. What she says goes. All right, Adam, Adam's on notice too. Don't fuck with the alpha.
We currently have me and Adam and Sylvia, Miera, and Sean Eaglehawk in our pack.
How much you want to bet Sean Eaglehawk isn't a Native American? They just thought it sounded super rad. I'm Jim Lizardskin, and my girlfriend's name is Jade Panther Fur. This is our buddy Mr. Eaglehawk. Really great naming scheme. Very, very deep. Really, really deep naming scheme. Let's dig in. Oh, alpha male howls. Oh my God, does Adam really exist? Holy shit, we're going to get to watch Adam show us how to howl. Oh, Adam, come on. You got to give me more than that. You think he did that when she threw herself off the bridge? You think he looked over the edge and he wanted to remember her properly, so he did this? Ripping pepperoni, fat ass. I'll always a woo for you. I wooed for you, fatty. oh God, there's more. My wolf noises.
Hello, everybody, again. I'm gonna adjust my position here. And so, I have a sore throat right now, so this might not work out, but...
Wow, God, spoiler alerts. Barking like a dog makes your throat sore. Who saw that coming? Maybe stop a-wooing all day and night. Also, I'm sure your mom and dad really appreciate you doing this in the front yard in front of the neighborhood. I'm sure the neighbors love it, and dad doesn't feel slightly embarrassed about it at all.
My dad just went in the house, so I was thinking of doing this, and no one seems to be around, so I can do this. So I'm doing my... Therian noises. Mostly wolf noises. Can't do my fox noises. Probably can't do my cat noises, so I'm gonna do my wolf noises. I can't do my horse noise right now either.
They have a horse noise? No! What the fuck is a horse noise? Can you picture this motherfucker making horse noises at you? Oh, I bet your parents fucking hate you!
So, just my wolf noise. So, if you don't know how to howl, you go like this with your thumbs out and cup your hand like this, and then you howl. Adam's really good at it. I'm getting there.
Look at them looking over their shoulder and shit like they don't want to be embarrassed. It's far too late for that. All right, we've watched your other videos. The neighborhood knows you're insane. You may as well just own it. You may as well just fucking completely own it and dress up like a wolf and run around the front yard. Because fuck it. What are they going to do about it?
I'm kind of nervous because I just heard laughter and anyone's going to hear me. Okay. Yeah, now I'm totally embarrassed. Because I swear I heard someone.
They're hearing people. People are watching out of their windows across the street and laughing at them. Like, they're aware of that. Like, the neighborhood is laughing at you. And you're still filming this.
I don't know. What the hell? Then barking? I can't whine right now because of my throat, but yeah, someone was outside and I just heard their car leave.
Oh, this is amazing. Have we found, like, the... This might be, how do I put this? They might be like the golden example. A fursuiter, otherkin, transgendered, crazy person that now believes they're being gang stalked by their neighbors. Is that possible? Have we found a unicorn? Have we found a fucking unicorn today? Is that possible?
Embarrassing. Probably people think I'm a freak now. I'm proud of being a freak. Leave me alone.
I'm proud of being a freak. Look how half-hearted and low energy this shit is. You're going out in the front yard, bark like a dog if you're going to do it. Fuck your neighbors. Stand up. Look your neighbor in the eye and you growl at them. You let them know you're the fucking alpha of the Indigo Blue Pack. They better watch their ass or you're going to eat their cat.
I can't bark with a sore throat. It sounds like a dying dog. Okay. Well, that's my wolf noises.
Yes, chat, that's perfect. I love that term. I'm stealing it. We have found a lunicorn. We found our very own lunicorn. That's what I'm calling it. It's a convergence of all insanity into one single individual.
My dad just came back out, so I am done this video.
My dad just came out of the house, and he's holding a baseball bat. And he's just looking at me with a look of hatred. And I think this might be my last video, guys. Yeah, he's walking over here shaking his head saying, I told you, if you bark one more fucking time if you bark in the front yard. All right, guys, don't forget to favorite, like, and subscribe. Oh, we need to find more. I think we're going to just take a journey down the lunicorns. Oh my God. Holy fucking shit. They have real baby dolls. What the fuck is going on? Who is this person? What is going on? Who the fuck is this person?
Sorry, I got a cold. This is Isabella, and she's my doll that I am using for practice, I guess.
Oh, what? Okay, Lunicorn, what practice are you doing with a little real-life baby doll? I don't know where this is going.
For when I have real kids.
I don't think that's something you should be concerning yourself with. I have a feeling you're not going to be having children. Maybe just skip this part of learning motherhood because you're not ever going to be a mother.
But yeah, I mean, I really like Reborn dolls, and I want to get one. She's not...
Oh, that's the name of it. That's a creepy-ass Chucky doll shit. The Reborn dolls. They look like... They're the human-like babies that crazy women have. You know, like cat ladies and spinsters. They can't get a man, and they're like 50. And they just... They completely have a breakdown. They want a baby, but their ovaries are dried husks, and they can never have a child. They buy Reborn baby dolls and make their cuck husbands pretend it's a living thing. That's what I was trying to think of.
A Reborn doll, but, yeah. She was real enough looking to convince my grandmother. Like, my grandmother thought she was real when she saw the picture.
Oh, I bet this crazy fucker is, like, going on Facebook, "Hey, Grandma, look at my baby. This is my baby. It's real baby, Grandma. I have a real baby now. Oh, my new hairstyle. Maybe go with the old one. My gender identity. This is a gold mine. All right, let's... Wait, I'm sorry. I'm not dead. Let's hear this update.
Everybody, apparently I found out that everyone thought I killed myself.
You don't say, champ! Is it maybe because you look like Frankenstein? I don't know. I don't understand what kind of biological look this is. You've got a Neanderthal's brow ridge, because I don't think it actually sticks out of your head. If we were to paint it metallic, you would look like some Japanese robot. You'd look like a mecha with that brow ridge. And I don't know what this is! This is clearly the sign of interbreeding, or inbreeding, or at least fetal alcohol. There's so many syndromes going on right now with this face. I don't know what the fuck is up. Nice haircut, by the way. It was probably a very nice bowl you used. We can see it's clearly defined line that you stuck on your head and cut yourself.
But I'm alive. Or am I?
Any time you have to put up a video saying I didn't kill myself is probably a clear sign that you are eventually going to kill yourself. What? We have to dig farther back to find what spurred this one on.
Okay, well, I am kind of peed because the fact that a bunch of people thought I was dead. They started to spread a rumor about someone that didn't... I don't even remember.
Come on, use your words. Mental shift back into a person and string them together. Come up with coherent sentences. And give us a narrative so we understand why your neighborhood thought you killed yourself.
Pretty sure they didn't... They didn't take part in the bullying. And they were spreading the rumor that they were the one that was bullying me, and they were the reason why I killed myself.
I don't know if you guys caught that, but the kids at her school shit on her so much that they try to brag to each other that they're the ones responsible for getting her to kill herself. I want you to imagine a high school cafeteria full of children trying to claim credit for getting Igor to kill itself.
But I'm not dead. I'm alive. See? I'm alive. I just took a break for a while because it was getting to me to the point that I felt like killing myself, but
This sounds like 14D underwater chess by the bullies. Their plan was to spread rumors that they made her kill herself, to get her to kill herself, so they could claim credit later. There's a Deadpool at this kid's school, where all the bullies get together to see who's going to win the fucking jackpot. If you're a parent, and you have a weird fucking kid that's into weird dumb shit like this particular person is, don't let them have a YouTube account. It's asking for trouble. This person is putting up the wrong type of shit on the internet and just asking for fucking trouble.
I wasn't stupid enough to do that because I have people that would miss me, and I know that they would. So, I did do something stupid, though. I cut my wrist.
Holy shit. And it's a cutter, too.
And it bled a little bit, but it didn't hurt that much. I guess it would have hurt more if I didn't have so much pain inside.
My heart hurts so much it makes me wanna woo!
But, I'm not letting the drama get to me anymore. I'm just laughing at it or ignoring it or killing them with kindness or just no more fueling the fire, because they fueled the fire and then I fueled the fire and then it just was a big explosion. And I'm not dead, and please leave Silky Moth alone because they had no part in it at all. So it was a bunch of Therians that I was actually trying to stick up for other Therians that were being mocked by.
Okay, wait a minute. And so it wasn't kids at your school that have a death pool to drive you to suicide. It's actually other crazy Otherkins. You're so insane that the other Therians, the other mental cases that believe they're werewolves and shit, are trying to drive you to kill yourself. What is going on in the Indigo Blue Pack?
Little kids. And not just little kids. Other people mock too. Like adults mock. So I was sticking up for them. And they took it the wrong way. And they started to say horrible things about me. And I just read a comment now that someone told me to drink bleach. And I...
Did you? Did you read a comment where somebody told you to drink bleach? That's shocking. I didn't see that coming.
I'm like, wow, harsh. And then I just laughed it off. Because I'm like, I ain't gonna drink bleach. That's disgusting.
I'll only drink Pine Sol, you fucking plebs. Drink bleach? That's beneath me. Therians only drink the finest of cleaning products. Okay? Bleach is for poor people.
That's a bad way to go. Maybe you should drink some bleach and see how it tastes.
Oh, blown the fuck out. You try to banter with the Alpha Chad? Look what happens, little dog. You came to fuck with the wolf. You got bit. Oh, tell me to drink bleach? Why don't you do it? Nuh-uh. You, bro. You. Blown the fuck out. Step back. Step back from the wolf pack.
Yeah, okay. Anyways, I'm alive, and apparently there was a bunch of videos. People were having tributes for my death.
We have to find these. People were making fucking internet videos for their death. There are memorial pages for this retard. We need to find them. I need to explore who the fuck this is. Oh, there's so many videos. Let's dig a little deeper. There's so much shit to look through. Why, I haven't posted off Five Nights at Freddy's. I think I need to start a list. All right, they have Reborn Dolls, Transgender, Fursuiter, Otherkin, Attention-Whoring Fake Suicider, and now we've got Five Nights at Freddy's. It keeps growing. The list keeps growing. Our Lunicorn becomes more majestic every moment we scroll through their shit. Okay, so let's go a little deeper here. Okay, this is Rubby Fursuit Unboxing. Oh, well, I want to watch them unbox their fursuit.
My fursuit had arrived, and now I'm going to open it. If I can.
God, they even laugh like they're mentally handicapped. That laugh that they do. Where's Mom and Dad for this? Mom and Dad have to know that this is happening. Why haven't they stepped in and said, stop. Just stop. For God's sake, we'll buy you a car or something. Just stop.
And there's a drawing on the side, and her,
Company,
yeah. Nova Fur is right there.
Holy shit! Oh! I see what you're saying, chat. Yes, JF is happily in a relationship right now, but if that ever goes south, we might have found him a perfect match. We might have found a winner here.
Just like Christmas.
I know. Oh my God, moment of truth. I gotta take my glasses off. There's her business card. Not so much, unless you'd like to see snow falling into the water. We've been talking about this all week, watching this system of going to bubble back in towards the coastline. And it's so big! Cold north wind, but we have that cold north wind now. We have a little bit of rain falling in Port Hawkesbury. It's so big! Oh my God!
I like how they sent it in a trash bag, because that's where it fucking belongs. It's like the creator of this abomination was trying to subtly hint at where it should go. In the garbage.
It's so cute! My baby's here. Bye. I gotta put it on.
Just wow. And they wear it out in public. God, I want to see what the reaction is to this shit. Could you imagine bringing your children to the arcade for a fun-filled afternoon and a retarded lady in a fucking wombat hat walks up to your kid? Hello, do you want to be my baby? What size tail is this? What fucking size tail is that? That's a big black tail you got up your ass there, champ. This is the sort of person that should not be allowed in public. What the fuck, Mom? What are you doing? You're a parent. You need to step in and stop this. Is anyone else noticing there are no other people in the arcade right now? They've scared off every other patron. When all the parents saw this freak show walking into the arcade, they grabbed their 5-year-olds and ran for the fire exit.
Did she try?
Thank you. I'm just really stunned. I'm really stunned at what we're looking at here. Fursuit. My dad and my fursuit head? Oh, dude. Dad, what the fuck? What are you... Oh, did it freeze up on me? It might have froze up on me. Even YouTube is so disgusted with this, it doesn't want to continue. Oh, technical issues. Hold on. Oh, oh, there we go.
My dad has my fursuit head on. And he's being a goof.
Okay. James is still on my side.
Okay, you know what? I'm calling it now. The parents are responsible. If this retard killed itself, it's mom and dad's fault. You knew at every step of the way your insane daughter was doing weird shit. Okay, you bought them the fursuits, you bought them the real dolls, you let them post shit on YouTube. You knew they were in the yard barking at the neighbors. You fucking knew what was going on, and you didn't stop it. You thought it was all cute. It was all fun and games until it becomes society's problem. Some poor bastard making $8 an hour has got to scrape her off the sidewalk under the bridge because you couldn't put your fucking foot down. It's a trap. It's a trap. Don't go into daddy's bedroom. Or he's took your fursuit head and went into his bedroom. Run. Run out of there. Don't go in there. It's a fucking trap. I'm telling you, kid.
Okay,
stop. Holy shit. Oh my god. All right. We'll dig into this one later on. I'm going to bookmark that. This is going to get saved under the need to investigate what the fuck is the matter with this person tab. Okay. Let me see if I can find it. Where is it? Okay. That was the mental shifting. I've got that all. Yeah, let's take a look at
tonight truth.
Let's take truth. A look. There we go. Wolfie Blackheart talking about Therians and Otherkin. I want to tell you a heartwarming story about a Otherkin that decapitated a dog. Because, you know, it's a normal thing to do. It's what their kind does after they awoo and mourn the dead. So let's take a look at Wolfie Blackheart.
Stranger than fiction, the investigation into a beheaded dog leads police to a self-proclaimed wolf girl.
James Munoz has been following this story since last week. He's live at police headquarters tonight with the latest. James?
Sarah Rodriguez goes by the name Wolfie. She claims she's a werewolf. She's into taxidermy, but this time she may have gone too far.
Wolf is wolf, so full werewolf. I'm half human, half wolf.
Sarah.
She may have gone too far. Our little girl, Wolfie Blackheart, is into funny, interesting things. But she may have gone too far when she ripped the head off a dog. News at 11.
Rodriguez prefers to be called Wolfie. She wears a tail, a collar, and a harness.
I am agnostic. I believe anything is possible, and I don't have a set religion.
A group of people, mostly online, have accused her of beheading a dog.
I didn't kill any animal. I wouldn't. Like I said, I'd be more likely to hurt a human than a dog any day, and even then, very, very, not really possible. I'm pretty friendly.
The dog's name was Rigsby. He went missing on January 2nd. A photo of someone holding his head is on the internet. Now 18-year-old Wolfie is under investigation.
I didn't get him as Rigsby. My friend brought him as her dog, who got hit by a car, named Shadow.
And was he alive at the time?
Dead. He was kind of stiff.
Wolfie claims she's done nothing illegal. She says,
I've done nothing wrong. My friend stole the dog, and it mysteriously died. Then I ripped its head off and posed for pictures on Instagram.
There's a group of people harassing her. They've even hacked into her personal accounts online.
They put child porn on my profile. A lot of bad, nasty stuff. I've been getting death threats, phone calls, a whole bunch of stuff.
A few years ago, Wolfie was arrested at an area high school for carrying a large knife on campus. She wasn't enrolled as a student at the time.
Oh, I didn't take the knife to school knowingly. I had it in my bag for my dad.
She was also once arrested on a burglary charge.
I was proved not guilty because I didn't do it. I was in the woods nearby, which I'm always in the woods. And they caught me and my friend in the woods.
Look at that fucking haircut. It's like a cross between emo and screamo. I don't even know what to call it, really. Hiding in the woods. That was the knife she brought to school she didn't know she had. That thing is like 3 feet long. How do you not know you have that on you? It's not like you accidentally put it in your pocket and forgot about it.
We didn't do the break-in. I don't carry them around.
Okay, just keep going. Animal cruelty investigators have been to Wolfie's home before. Right now there's an open investigation surrounding complaints. She has too many animals living in unsanitary conditions, and those dogs often fight. And in 2007, another complaint regarding animal mutilation.
Well, just lovely. And yes, chat, there are updates on what happened to Wolfie. I just wanted to throw it in there when we're talking about the other kin community, the Therians. Let's see, where should we go next? I've got a couple documentaries on these crazy fucks that are lined up, which are good. Which are good. And then about another guy that wants to change his name into a dog. He wants to be legally recognized as a pupper. Best of luck with that, pal, I guess. Which are good. And then about another guy that wants...
What are you doing here?
Okay, sorry. A little feedback loop there. Whoopsie-daisy.
Change
days.
His name into a dog.
What the fuck? Okay, there we are. I'm being a boomer. I'm fucking shit up, chat. I think
is this a way?
Yeah, there we go. This is the guy that wants to live his life as a dog. And, of course, good old-fashioned Dr. Phil coming with the hard-hitting stories. Let's jump over. Here we go.
Way of avoiding life for you in other ways? You're 48. You're a virgin, right?
Yes.
You've never been on a date. You don't have a job. You just put on a paper dog suit and walk around town, which doesn't seem to me to be a highly productive course in life.
Well, I feel it makes me more social because it's something that I engage in with people, wearing the costume outwardly, going around the city, and I kind of...
The dude's a living fucking fire hazard. I like the outfit, made together with used pom-poms from cheerleaders that ran away in fear. But, you know, one misplaced match and this motherfucker's going to the burn ward.
And get friends that way, too, you know, people who interact with me as a dog. And owners, mostly dog owners, really like the situation, you know, of me being a dog on the, you know, outside and
yeah.
stuff.
How many of them have asked you to come home for dinner?
People do say, they have a thing, can I take you home? They actually...
I don't think they're saying they want you to come to their house. I think they said they want to find you a home. You know, like a mental facility. Somewhere for special care to be given for your insanity, maybe, is what they're trying to tell you.
They say that to me many times. For fun. I think they're just
having
don't fun.
Don't go.
I know.
Don't go. If somebody's wanting to take you home, don't go.
I don't know. Yeah, I'm safe. I know the safety rules, so I'm good.
Yeah. What do you do for money?
Well, my...
Oh, I suck dick on the sidewalk. You know, basic normal things. Put on my pom-pom uniform, pretend to be a dog. Let hobos, ejaculate my asshole. Is that safe to say on TV? I let homeless people shoot their loads up my ass. That's how I sustain myself. That's how I make money, Dr. Phil. I give hand jobs to poor people on the streets. I suck a lot of cum out of a lot of cocks. Let's be real here. I'm dedicated to pleasing dicks, Dr. Phil.
My parents, my mom established a trust fund for me. I own my own home. I kind of have just, you know, it doesn't cost too much for me to live.
Yeah.
And I kind of live simply. I feel like the dog philosophy is... just a simple life a little bit.
Yeah.
So it's, and dog food doesn't cost that much. So yeah. I'm not.
They eat out of a fucking dog bowl. Of course you do. Yeah. Living the life fully dedicated.
Not doing too bad.
Now you don't really think that you're part dog.
In some way I have to believe that I am.
Okay.
Because of circumstances over the years that have shown me that there must be something there because it's that strong of a thing for me.
So you think you could be a dog trapped in a human body?
Yeah, in some way. I don't know how it is. I don't know how it happened, but I do really believe that it's a possibility that maybe I was intended to be a dog somehow. I don't know.
I'm going to guess that this is some kind of childhood trauma. Maybe your dad beat you with a belt. Maybe an uncle molested you. Maybe you fucking just fell somewhere and hit your head on the curb. That would be my explanation for why you eat kibbles and bits.
Yeah, is it possible that you, like, went to a movie with your dad early on about a dog and you have warm feelings and memories of that, and then you saw other dog things and they're all kind of always happy endings with a soundtrack behind them, and so you just kind of get caught up in...
I don't know if you caught that, but I think Phil's on to our boy here. And yeah, that is a dude. Happy endings, wink wink. He knows what's up. He knows how this guy's supporting himself. How you getting all those dog treats? I know what's up. Happy endings.
In that fantasy?
People have said, you know, that it might be a fantasy that I have in the past.
Well, it's fantasy. But... And listen, again,
I know.
Listen, it's... People do this for a hobby. That's okay. But you're missing an awful lot of life.
All right, I think there's a clip, too, of this dude. He lost his court case. He went into court to be declared a dog or some shit. And he lost that one. Boomer the dog, American furry. Oh, wait, this is a whole documentary.
Take the name Boomer. Start.
All right, we got... Okay, let me try it like this, chat. We got two choices. We've got a Boomer the dog documentary. What was the other one? There was another fucking... Oh, wait, actually, we can start with this.
Hold on. Time once again for your morning...
All right, we'll do a quick update on Boomer. And then we got two documentaries on Otherkin lifestyle I think you're going to like. But let's find out how his court case went to be legally declared a fucking mutt.
Morning, Brew, and joining me this morning, as always, is Larry Hanley. And this morning, we're talking about the canine crowd. Two very different stories, believe me. A Pittsburgh man, we're going to start with him. He believes his spirit is more dog than human. Take a look at this guy, but a judge won't let him change his name. He wanted to change his name, get this, to Boomer the dog. Legally, really? He wanted his name to be Boomer the dog. Who wouldn't? This is a look at Gary Matthews. That's his real name, but for the most part of his 44 years, he hasn't acted or even dressed like a human being. Instead, he's taken on the persona of...
How depressing is this, by the way, chat, that this crazy fuck who wears the world's worst dog costume and eats fucking kibbles and bits, he has a house. This motherfucker owns a home. I don't know how he does it. Maybe mom and dad bought it for him. Maybe he's just a rich kid. I don't know. I haven't looked into him. But he's coming from a house. You're all out there busting your ass to survive. Maybe you're in college. Maybe you just got a job. You know, you're working your way up in the world. And this psychotic fuck that wants to live the life of a dog has the luxury of a home.
Of a dog. This story gets better and better. His house is actually filled with dog movies, books, and toys. Gary says he just feels more comfortable dressing in his Boomer costume than being, well, a human being like the rest of us. He's also been spotted at furry conventions for years wearing the costume.
You're right. I do zone out when crazy people talk occasionally. He said, chat saying, trust fund. I don't know. It's just kind of when you run into a unicorn, it's a magical experience. It's like a double rainbow kind of thing. Well, you just get lost in it. You become transfixed on what you're looking at, and everything kind of fades to darkness around you. It's a really weird phenomena. I don't know how to describe it better than that. This is another unicorn. I mean, look at it. Look what it's doing with its hair to make fake dog ears. Just up there. It's very bizarre. It's transfixing. I can't look away.
The unemployed computer tech, more on that.
I was going to ask what he did for a living.
The unemployed computer tech even walks through his neighborhood as Boomer the dog, as we saw in the video, and that's why in a very bold move that he petitioned the court to have his name legally changed to Boomer the dog. A judge, however, felt the name change was just too confusing.
How much do you want to bet these dudes wished that television would let them say what they really wanted to say? You see those smiles on their face? I bet you these guys bullied people like him in school. And I bet they just want to look into the camera and go, this dude is a fucking faggot. But they can't. So they've got to try to say it in a subtle, nice way.
It would have been better if he worked in a pet shop somehow.
Unemployed, though. Perhaps not surprising. Can you imagine that resume coming across your desk? Name, Boomer the dog.
Yeah, that's a little odd. Maybe a good call on that judge's part, by the way.
That story's a...
Yeah, I used to shove fuckers like him into lockers. Taught him a lesson early and often back in the day. But apparently Boomer just didn't learn it hard enough. I better go get the hose and pay him a visit. Okay, let's see. Yeah, we're going to go with this one, I think. This is a documentary. A fucking documentary. They call it, I swear to God, Species Dysphoria Disorder. That's a fancy name for lunatic. Species Dysphoria Documentary. I think I'm an animal. Of course. Can't just call crazy crazy. Gotta give it a fancy name and act like it's not insane. So let's take a look at this.
What would you do if you felt you had been born into the wrong species?
When I started feeling that I was non-human, I was around 10 or 11.
Oh, I have a feeling. Okay, does it look to anybody else like he actually has a hole in his pants that the tail goes into? I think this might be a legitimate ass plug tail that this dude is wearing to the fucking bowling alley.
Increasing number of people believe they are more animal than human.
I would definitely say that I have species dysmorphia.
I have these hands and this body, but internally...
It's all the same. It's like the... You know, what is it? South Park kind of called attention to it with the emo kid skit, where it's like they all want to be individuals and fight and rebel against the system, but they're all cookie cutter in how they do it because they all shop at fucking Hot Topic together and wear black mascara and shit. There's a uniform for this brand of crazy, and they all fucking wear it. It's all got the dog collar, fake tail. It's like, it's just, they all shop at the same place for the same shit and act crazy in the same way. It's really bizarre.
I am a leopard.
On all levels except physical, I am a wolf.
This is the guy! Fantastic, let's back that up. On all levels except physical, I am a wolf. Oh, woo!
Internally, I am a leopard.
On all levels except physical, I am a wolf.
Joined by a belief system and a growing internet presence, these people are meeting and forming relationships.
We are raccoon and leopard. There's not too relevant to whether or not we love each other.
Primal instincts take over, and before you know it, you're clawing and biting your other half to pieces and wondering why the both of you are enjoying it so much.
For the first time, we are welcomed into the world of human animals.
I began to get concerned because it sounded like almost like mental illness to me.
Oh, did it? Did it almost sound like mental illness to you? Not quite at the threshold, though. What would push it over for you, honey? What? It almost sounded like mental illness. Almost. Not quite there yet. Dressing up like a dog, barking at the neighbors, pissing on trees to mark territory, shoving tails up their assholes. Not quite mental illness, though. With your nice white woman wearing Native American shit, crazy-ass hippie lady, what would you define as mentally ill, then?
My child telling me that he's half animal.
These are paperworks for my name change to my wolf name, which is Shiro Wolf.
What's he dressing up like?
In our changing world, a new subculture of humanity is evolving. These people don't believe that they are human at all. Identifying with a particular species, they are collectively known as Otherkin and Therians. Some choose to dress up as the species they think they are. Otherkin and Therians live all over the world and share one common belief.
Oh, I love to picture just normal families just out doing normal things. And in comes a parade of freaks, dressed like lunatics, to some fucking family event. Here they come to the arcade, here they come to the bowling alley. How am I going to explain to my child what this pervert sexual kink really is about? I want to protect my child, let them have a nice childhood, and this motherfucker in the fursuit's got to ruin that for me.
They think they are animals.
People have asked me, well, you know, do you ever get sick of it? Do you ever get sick of thinking about it? Do I ever get sick of thinking about my elbow? You know, I don't really have to think about it. It's just there. It's just a part of who you are.
Checkmate, bigots. Okay? Just because I believe I'm an octopus doesn't mean I'm insane. Do you ever think about your kneecaps? I didn't fucking think so. All right? This is the 21st century. All right? And you need to stop judging me and just let me live my life. I'm not sushi to be eaten. I am an octopi. And you don't think about your fucking kneecaps, do you?
Caleb Karges lives on the outskirts of Buffalo, New York. He is not your usual teenager.
My species is, well, definitely a wolf. Lately, I've been leaning more towards red wolf specifically, not only because the entire the type of environments I like, but also because of the way I act. If I could look in the mirror and choose what I saw, I would see an anthropomorphized version of myself that was half wolf, half human.
Caleb is part of the growing phenomenon of...
I fucking love these pictures. It just is so perfect. There's nothing that just... It sums everything up. Having a picture like this on a social media account or on the wall in your room basically just tells everybody what they need to know. Hello, I am fucking insane. When I look into the mirror, I think I'm a giant 7-foot-tall werewolf or a dragon. Or, you know, I guess maybe there aren't a lot of octopus out there. Octopi, whatever. Not a lot of them. But this sums it up. This is pretty much a picture's worth 1,000 words, and this sums that up perfectly.
People who believe in some way that they are an animal.
We believe that mentally, or at least cognitively, we are more connected with the animal side of ourselves than we are the human side of ourselves. And whether that be just the way we try to act in our life or the way we try to communicate with the people we love or our friends, it's something that's very noticeable. It's something that needs to be constantly purged in your head because you constantly have to realize, oh, that's right, I think differently.
Therians identify psychologically and spiritually with an animal. And since the age of 6, Caleb has believed he is a wolf.
I have a couple tails. This is the one that I've been wearing for the most part. It's a little bit less realistic. This one's a bit more cartoony, but I like it.
It's less realistic. God, what makes it less realistic, champ? What makes that tail not as realistic as it could be? Could it be the fact that you are a human being and not a red wolf? And you look insane when you staple it to your ass cheeks? I also like how they're all like, I identify as a wolf. It's who I really am on the inside, as he sits at his fucking desk using a computer. Last time I checked, most animals don't know how to use technology. If you really want to live the life of a wolf, why don't you get butt naked and live in the forest for a few weeks, and then come back and tell me how much you like that animal kingdom shit?
Because it's easier to manage. I used to have, what was a decommissioned fursuit tail, and it bothered the hell out of me because it was just like, it was just inconvenient in every way, and this one's like a lot more cute and a lot more playful. So to go out in public with it, I think it fits a lot more. But it fits me, and it fits my size, and it has my colors. That's actually where I sleep. Right now there's a cat where I sleep, but normally that's where I sleep, and it's mostly computers in here, actually. I like it quite a lot because it gets quite warm in here, and as a red wolf, I like warm temperatures.
Caleb lives at home with Dad Jim, brother Chris, and his mom, Mary Ellen.
I'm disappointed in you, Jim. How could you let your wife wear earrings that disgusting? And why aren't you beating your son? All right, you need to step it up. You need to step it up a little bit with the patriarchal role in that household.
Well, when you first told me about being a Therian, and you said you felt you were part animal, and you said to me, Mom, what you look at when you see me, this is not who I am. I'm actually somebody very different. I questioned if you were schizophrenic.
She knows. She knows in her soul her son is crazy, and she just doesn't want to admit it. I guarantee you Mom and Pops are having conversations at that little dinner table when crazy Caleb ain't around, talking about what facility they're going to house him in when he hits 18.
Or mentally ill. And then when you told me that, when I asked how long you had felt this way, and you told me it went all the way back to when you were around 6 years old, that you had been carrying this with you, that you really felt that part of you was this wolf. I've come to really accept it and support it. I get a little bit sad sometimes that Caleb is so involved in his own world that he seldom comes into our world.
I don't know. Somebody in chat, is that other kid adopted? Let's take a look. Oh, we get a view of him.
And then when you told me that...
Is this little boy adopted? And if he is, how unlucky is he? Could you imagine you're at the orphanage? And they're like, hey, it finally happened. Like, I know you're like 12 and all, and you usually don't get adopted once you get up there in age, but we found a family that wants you. You're going to have a Christmas. You're going to have people buy you presents. It's great. And you're all excited and shit, and they drive you off in the van or whatever. And you show up at this person's house, and the first thing that greets you is Caleb in the front yard prancing around with a chew toy in his mouth as his mother sits there clapping at how proud she is her trans species son is expressing himself. Oh, that's our Caleb. We're so proud of Caleb. He's such a... Oh my God, he's so magical. I'm so proud of my Caleb. Oh, I bet you just want to get back in that orphanage van and go right the fuck back.
When I asked how long you had felt this way, and you told me it was...
...believe she can communicate with the spirit world.
I find that shamanism is not a religion, but it is a way of connecting with something deeper than yourself. It is a way of feeling that sense of the divine in this universe, and I honor everybody's path. And I feel the same way about what Caleb is doing. I think that that's a pain.
Oh, dude. Okay. Mom's responsible. We now know why Caleb is so fucked up. Mom's responsible. She kept telling him all this shaman shit this white chick has no idea about. She's telling him, oh, we have animal spirits. And he took it to be literal. She's trying to talk about shamanism. Oh, animal spirits and nature and shit. And Caleb, being a stupid kid, listening to his mom talk about dumb shit, thought she was being legitimate with him, and now believes that he's a wolf. It's her fault completely.
Yeah, that they'll take it. I think it'll evolve for them. Be really interesting to see what happens to him 10 years from now.
Oh, I bet it will.
The environment in this house is very warm, and it's very open, which is probably why a lot of my friends like coming over here, and we like hanging out and doing things.
Caleb is not unique in his beliefs. He is part of a small Faerian community of people in Buffalo. They include Stephen, a leopard, and Timothy, a raccoon.
Timothy, a raccoon! And then there's Christopher, the squirrel, and Billy, the goat. God, this kid's got money. Look at all this shit. He's living a pampered lifestyle, doesn't have to think about supporting himself, when the reality of the working world comes crushing in on him. Oh, God.
Together, they run an amateur radio show from his bedroom. It broadcasts to hundreds of people like them all around the world.
Hey, guys, welcome back. This is episode 102. I am your host of this evening, Paradox the Wolf.
I am your blue fox host, Pharaoh.
I am your co-host in training, Shroud the Leopard.
I'm your guest, Minok the Raccoon.
All right, next email that I got here. Hey guys, my name is Kobe, and I am an orange, blue, and white male German Shepherd. I am also bisexual, and I am 19 years old, and I'm having some huge issues with my parents in relation to being Faerian. Is there any help explaining this to them?
How did you do it?
I don't even remember.
Oh.
I barely touched on it, because my parents just didn't care. My mom just wanted me to be safe. My dad said that I could have whatever beliefs I wanted as long as I wasn't hurting anyone.
Oh, you had
myself.
Easy too.
Yeah, it was easy.
Let me translate that for you. Mom is probably on uppers or drinks herself to death every day. You know, one of those suburbanite women. And dad, when he says, "It's just as long as you're not hurting others," what he really said specifically, word for word, verbatim, was, "I don't care what queer shit you're into, just don't fuck the family cat." That's what dad said. That's what dad's concern was, the safety of the cat in the house.
When my mother found out, she asked me if she had done anything wrong as a parent. and I was like, no.
My parents always the live and let live type, as long as you're happy kind of people.
Right.
So as far as how I had to do it, it's not like I could offer advice from my personal experience.
Yeah.
Because I had it easy.
Caleb and his friends are fortunate that they are content feeling like animals.
No, Caleb and his friends are fortunate that they live in a first world country. Because if Caleb and his friends tried this shit in Iran, or somewhere else like that, they would be thrown from fucking rooftops. Caleb and his friends are lucky they don't live in Africa, where they would put tires around their waist and light them on fire and beat them with stones. That's what Caleb and his friends are lucky about.
For others, though, this is not the case.
These are some of my wolf shirts. I've got probably over 50. This is my absolute favorite of them all, and it's one of my newer ones. It's got like the wolf and the moon, and it's the full body wolf, and it's purple. I just love it, it's beautiful.
18-year-old Matthew Schimmel lives in Brunswick, Georgia.
That's my diploma from when I graduated high school, and they had actually put Wolfie on the side of it. This is really cool. This, when I turn it on, it'll sound like a waterfall light up and the wolf will howl.
Hey son, what time is it? Oh dad, it's a woo o'clock. He got a fucking clock that a woos at him. It's amazing.
It's getting there. So yeah, I've always loved this one. I've got a whole bunch of wolf stuff. I've got two wolf posters. That's a picture of the wolf that I adopted. These are wolves as well. And yeah, that's pretty much it in my room.
It is not just wolf memorabilia that sets Matthew apart from other teenagers.
It's his crippling autism. And the bad smell.
In a personal, integral, and non-physical level, I am a wolf. It's very spiritual for me. I believe I have the spirit of a wolf. It's also very psychological. I behave like a wolf. I feel when I refer to myself, I am a wolf. Basically, other than the fact that I have a human body and human flesh, I am a wolf. I can't really give you a number of how many Therians are out there. I mean, there's hundreds of thousands in communities that I know about and that I'm a member of. Obviously, there's wolves. I'm a wolf.
I know, we got that. You've told us you're a wolf about 80 times. Here's my question for you as I'm doing this documentary. Were you adopted? Are you Barbara Walters' real son? Because you sure believe a Wawa things. So I just want to see, are you related to her? Is that a bit of a speech impediment? Did you get that when you let a wolf fuck you?
You know, cats, foxes, domestic cats, tigers, lions, flies. I've met, believe it or not, several insects. To myself, I see a black wolf on all fours walking. And that's how I want to be pictured a lot of times.
All I can hear now is his using W's. It's in everything. It's this wah, 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 wah. He sounds like a Peanuts parent at this point. It's just, he's got an issue with his W's.
Because that's what I am, you know. You see me as this person, and I see myself as a wolf.
Growing up and believing something that no one else could see meant that Matthew had a tough time at school.
Day-to-day life at school was a living hell in every sense of the word.
They used to beat me for their amusement. All the kids would put me in lockers and kick it. The jocks would gather around me in the locker room and just spit in my face and call me a nigger nerd. It was terrifying.
The only reason I survived was because of my very few close friends who I am still fiercely loyal to this day. The same loyalty a wolf would have to his pack.
I'm always at home, most of the time, and my mom's at home most of the time, so.
One of those loyal friends from school is Jade.
The first thing I noticed was the tail. This is the first thing I noticed about him. And then he had a wolf shirt on.
Really? That was the first thing you noticed? It wasn't the smell? I bet you could smell this dude at least a few blocks away. It's the tail, though. That's what caught your eye. Jeez, God, I'd love to date a boy. Who should I let ask me out on a date? Should I let the captain of the football team? No. No. How about the student that has a 4.0 GPA? No, probably not going to work out. Oh, I know. How about the dude that has flies circling him like a living pile of shit and a tail stapled onto his ass? That seems like love at first sight.
Jade is also a wolf and instantly bonded with Matthew due to their similar beliefs.
He was the one who actually brought up Therians. And at that time, I was still kind of new to the whole concept. Like, I knew that about, you know, me being...
Women are women regardless of the situation. She was new to it. Anytime a woman enters into a new group or relationship, they will become interested in whatever the guy is interested in. She just wanted attention. And she happens to be dating a crazy asshole that thinks he's a wolf. So now, of course, she too is a wolf. She totally is a wolf, guys.
A wolf, but I didn't know the technical term for it.
We just hang out here, really.
Yeah.
It's a nice place to go.
It's quiet.
It's quiet. You can meditate here. No distractions from random people, you know.
Chat, can I get an awoo from you? Can we answer Jade and Retard Boy's awoo? Can we out awoo the crazy people? Just give me an awoo. Let's awoo with them. It's a magical
quiet.
Thing.
It's quiet. You can meditate here. No distractions from random people. You know?
Random people. Come on. Woo! There you go.
It
welcome to the
feel
pack.
I feel connected being here because this is where I'd kind of be, you know, in my natural environment. Well, there's more spiders over there.
It means a lot to me that, you know, he has included me in his pack and kind of taken me in. Because, like, for the longest time, it seemed like nobody was there.
Awesome.
Yeah.
It's like
I don't normally get to do that.
The only dude in America who, when you tell him his chick is a dog, he's like, yeah, totally. He takes it as a compliment.
It's a huge release because you kind of have to bottle so much up inside when you're certain places and you can just let it all out.
Not only limited to America, people who identify with animals live all over the world. Ben and Kimberly live on a farm in West Sussex, in the remote countryside of England. They are one of the handful of other kin couples who are married.
Our relationship with our dog is definitely a pack relationship, much like...
I've already got really bad feelings about where this is going to go. I don't really trust furries and other kins with pets, I'm going to be straight up with you. And when he's talking about the special relationship they have with their dog, and how they're all a member of the same pack, fucking flags are flying up in the air right now.
Like it is with any other dog, really, but I think in our case it helps a lot more that we're kind of a little bit attuned to maybe the way he's thinking. He's maybe a little bit attuned to the way we're thinking. It's kind of like having a little version of us.
Ben and Kimberly feel that they share their bodies with the spirit of a wolf.
This is the drawing of Ben and myself that my friend Lorna did, which, as you can tell, is just absolutely beautiful. It's so nice to have a proper representation, like that I can say to people, okay, this is what we look like. Ben on the bottom there with the blue eyes. I'm the sort of ambery-eyed wolf with the horns. For my 21st birthday, I got a tattoo, which is sort of like a weird sort of silhouette of my wolf side. I love it. It's just very me, and I'll never regret it because it's my soul, basically, inked on my leg.
Ben and Kimberly have been together for 8 years and married for 2.
The second I saw him, I was just completely attracted to him, more than I had been ever attracted to anyone. It was pretty much instantaneous, you know. I just felt really drawn to him. And I made it my kind of mission to find out who this guy was and who his friends were. And I kind of maybe even stalked him a tiny bit by finding out who his friends were and things like that. So, you know, a little bit creepy, but, you know, it worked out well for me in the end.
There was just something about her that seemed right to me on a kind of a subconscious level at the time.
Was it the fact that she was a fat chick that was desperate for any attention? And that she would put up with your crazy shit? Was that what you found special about her?
And when we were together, we just clicked.
Oh, I need your help.
All other kin and Therians have one thing that bonds them together. It's the very moment they realize they are an animal. This is a process called awakening.
Well, it came upon me around the age of 15, and as you can imagine, puberty being a difficult time for any teenager, and then you're having almost a whole nother puberty happen at the same time, and it's a frightening experience, you know, lots of new sensations and feelings that you're having to deal with.
Kimberly discovered this as a teenager. However, for Ben, the catalyst for his awakening was meeting her.
She shared her experiences with me. She listened to me more than anything, which was amazing to have someone to talk to that didn't look at you like you were a complete weirdo. And she was just there for me, really. I've been very fortunate to have someone.
People will do the craziest shit for sex. Like, it's amazing to me. You can meet somebody who is batshit insane, but because you want a little bit of sex, because you want to ride that dick or slam that pussy, you're willing to put up and even believe in the craziest shit that is out there.
With me at all times throughout it.
Ben and Kimberly's wolf sides rarely appear. However, they often come out in the bedroom.
As teenagers are, you know, we started dating and were very, like, eager,
enthusiastic,
and like the first couple of times we walked away with a couple of battle wounds, just sort of covered in bite and claw,
very intense,
and
a little
bit
scary at times.
I think it's because neither one of us had ever been with another wolf, and I think it just it brought it out in each other.
Your primal instincts take over, and before you know it, you're clawing and biting your other half to pieces, and wondering why the both of you are enjoying it so much. Only afterwards when you step back and you think,
whoa,
what have we done?
Yeah,
what have you done? How much do you want to bet he's the one that takes the knot? I bet he is. That look of shame on his face, I bet he is. She nuzzles his face as he takes the knot.
You know, it all makes sense now.
For both of them, they see their wolf side as a separate creature. Their wolves have their own names, personalities, and feelings. Kimberly has named her wolf side Luna. Unlike others, she has the ability to change into her animal side and let Luna talk for herself.
I normally don't let her speak because she has a bit of a mind of her own.
Holy shit, this crazy bitch is gonna channel the thoughts of her dog. Of course, this must be the beginning of mental shifting. Before it became like a real solid thing for lunatics, this is what they were doing. They were mind-reading puppers.
All right, hello. Hello. Yeah, I don't get let out very often. I tend to have a bad habit of running my mouth a bit and saying things I shouldn't do, so I tend to be kept a bit quiet, and caged is one way I tend to put it.
By Kim,
yeah. I kind of give her a bit of hell sometimes because she doesn't let me out as much as I should be let out. Unfortunately, she has main control over this body. I've got control over the dreams, so she doesn't really have a choice about what I do there. We've definitely lived quite a few lives together, and we've lived...
So she thinks she's fucking Dr. Doolittle up in here. Mind reading her dog. I bet that's how she justifies raping it. Right? I bet that's what she tells her other Therian friends. No, you don't understand. When we fuck our dog, I can read his thoughts and he's okay with it. Can you telepathically speak with dogs? I can. And he gave me consent. Affirmative consent at every step.
Lived lives on the other place as well as here. I don't know at what point our souls became one, but I feel that it has always been that way, and it's probably that way for a reason. So perhaps there's something we need to achieve or we need to accomplish.
Ben and Kimberly live on the farm with Ben's mom, Sue.
Oh, fuck. You can't let these people on a farm. Of course they live on a farm. I bet those poor horses. Jesus. Even horses have standards. They shouldn't be forced to fuck that fat ass. That's just sad.
She has only recently been told about the couple's wolf sides.
I don't think she was worried that she was going to get a bad reaction from me.
Of course she fucks the cows. They think she's one of them. Have you seen the size of this bitch? Have you seen Dr. Doolittle's girth? They're probably wondering why the fat cow's wearing a dress as it grazes in the field with them.
But she's worried that, as Ben is, I think, that I'm going to think they're a little odd, you know. And, they, you know, especially Kim, I mean, she's into all sorts of things. So it didn't really surprise me. But with Ben, it did a little. But Ben is a very deep guy. So a lot of the time, I don't know what's going on in his head, really. So
Sue has seen firsthand the impact that Kimberly has had on Ben.
I thought
it was very similar to the impact that Kimberly has on the ground when she walks over it. There's a deep depression where her hooves make contact with the soil. She's crushed him like she has the gravel road leading up to the farm. Half the shit this woman is shoveling in that barn is from Kimberly. She lives out there.
Really? And then I think you have sort of mixed emotions because you think, oh, where is it coming from? Is that something to do with me as a mum, you know?
Yeah, I got good feelings about this. I'm sure mom does too. Hey, here's my fat-ass daughter and her insane boyfriend. We live on a farm. She telepathically talks with dogs and thinks she's a wolf. I'm pretty sure she's fucking cows. And she's got a collection of baby dolls that are covered in blood. Totally normal. Nothing to be afraid of. But if you see her start snarling at you and she runs at you, dial 911 immediately.
The couple are preparing for their annual Halloween party.
For my Halloween party, I'm making it look like kind of a abandoned asylum kind of thing.
They are not only fortunate to have each other, they also have a group of accepting friends.
You think that dog knows what's going to go down tonight? Yeah, Halloween party. By the way, this documentary was filmed in April. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, Halloween party, quote unquote.
Josh was there when I awakened. Yeah. Josh is one of the few people I had to talk to about it.
It sounds really ridiculous, but it just came up in conversation. With certain circles, this stuff just comes up. You don't even expect it to come up, it'll just come up in conversation, and you're just like, yeah, sure, why not? On the internet, everyone is quite happy to talk about it. I guess it's a lot easier to talk about something when you don't have to stare someone in the eyes.
Ben is preparing to let his wolf side out as he dresses up as his favorite character, Wolverine.
I've chosen to.
What? What? I believe I'm a wolf. That's why I dress up as an X-Man. Oh, okay. Okay. I think I'm a cow. Call me Magneto. You know, all cows wear a helmet and a purple cape and are capable of affecting magnetics. Yeah, I'm Magneto the cow, and this is my wolf friend, Wolverine.
Go as Wolverine 1 because I like the character. I think he's fantastic. I've been a big fan of the X-Men, and also I think probably on a subliminal level to myself, because he somewhat matches my other kin side. I like his independence.
Yes, Chad, Moognito. There you go, Moognito. There, that's my other kin persona.
His devil may care attitude, the fact that he's, you know, alone a lot of the time. He's a big, strong, powerful character. Slot in between knuckles, three on each fist. Cheap, low budget.
Some of their friends also feel like they have an animal side.
I think my species, if I was to put it very basically, would be a wolf. But the thing is, it's not just a wolf. I'm a bit of a mix.
I'm not just a wolf. I'm a cybernetic wolf from the future. Half of me is a red wolf. The other half is titanium. And Wolverine rides around on me on Halloween, and we fight Moognito to see who gets to fuck the horses at night. It's a battle for the ages.
Everything.
You kind of look like some type of weird hybrid chimera creature, I guess. Like a wolf stag winged creature of some description, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know that it's got really a name. It just is.
Just a kind of, yeah, hybrid, I guess, is probably one way of putting it. Which isn't that uncommon. You do get hybrid kin. That does happen.
I've met quite a lot.
Yeah.
The Halloween party allows the couple to dress up and express their animal sides. It provides a rare opportunity to celebrate this with their friends.
Yeah, it feels good to be Wolverine, you know, just kind of letting myself go, beginning to get into character a little bit.
You look less like fucking Logan and more like a cowboy. I expect to see you in, what was that fucking movie, Rhinestone Cowboys sucking cock on a street corner as Dustin Hoffman pimps you out. Okay, you do not look like Wolverine, my friend.
Yeah, it's good.
I was going to say, because I don't know.
Amazing. 18-year-old Matthew Schimmel believes that he is more wolf than human. While most teenagers his age enjoy hanging out at the mall, Matthew enjoys shopping at the local pet store.
I used to have one kind of like this one, but it was bigger and it had reflective paw prints going on it. It doesn't look like they have the reflective.
I'm really sad because they don't let me shop at PetSmart no more. Because I fucked the poodles. And now I gotta buy my dog collars here. Okay, buddy.
And I used to love those. And these ones I really like just because they're so much bigger. It doesn't really feel strange buying them. A lot of times people don't even notice. They just think, oh, he probably has a dog. I'm looking for a collar or one of those bracelets with the paw prints on it.
Oh, I don't know if we've got any of those left.
Do you have the collars though?
No. The only collars I have are the general collars, but I know which one you're talking about. We carried those for a while.
The only animal I want to see this retard pretend to be is Yeller. That's who I want to see. You be old Yeller. And I'll help you other kin cosplay that one, buddy. You can LARP as old Yeller, and we'll see how that plays out.
We've got other, and then I've got some collegiate collars out front. But yeah, all these, and I have the nautical and the reflectives, but none with the paw print. I know exactly what you're talking about.
One of these will fit me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then oh, yeah.
They're good.
Okay, is that all for you?
Yes, ma'am.
All righty. $14.79.
Do you accept Monopoly money? Mama only give me Monopoly money because I'm not allowed out of the house no more.
Matthew is the youngest of four children and lives at home with parents Joe and Terry.
I know for me, I remember as a kid wanting to be a lion or wanting to be the biggest, strongest animal. I just saw at the zoo, so I thought maybe some of that type of childhood fantasy stuff was going on in the early beginning. But it wasn't too long after that he started getting into the spirit of a wolf and going in a little deeper. Part of me said, okay, this is the nonsense for the week.
The other part of me said, do they let people put their children up for adoption when they're over the age of 15? That part of me got on the phone and started calling around town. Sadly, that part of me was disappointed, so I'm stuck with him.
You know, next week he'll be into something else. I don't know how serious I took it when he first said it, so it was not a huge shock to the system. As it kept continuing, you get used to the idea, and okay, so my son thinks he's got the spirit of a wolf at first, and now it's a little more than that.
I feel so bad for Dad. I can imagine all his fucking friends coming over for a football game, and they're all drinking beer, and they all know this guy's son is a fucking retard. And I bet they love to make him try to explain it every time they get drunk. So, tell me about your son again, and the spirit of the wolf shit. tell me a little bit more about that, pal. How you raising your kids over here? I heard he hunts rabbits in the fields or something? You want to explain that to us?
As the years go by, you kind of learn to accept, okay, this is who he is, this is how he deals with it. It's not up to me to like it or not anymore.
Well, we knew from the time he was a baby, there was something different about him. You know?
We knew since he was born that it was a mistake. When he popped out of my vagina, the doctor just looked at me and shook his head. And that's when we knew we were in trouble.
Walker. As a little tiny thing, he would go to the doors because his first obsession was doors.
And I mean, it was not like your normal child, spank their hand, say no, and it would be an all-day job to try to keep them out of the cabinet doors.
At the age of 6, Matthew was diagnosed with Asperger's.
Oh boy, wow, I didn't see that coming. An autistic person wants to be a furry? What? What? Oh, if you have an autistic child, or a child on the spectrum, I guess they call it the spectrum now because it's not separated between Asperger's and autism, just do your kid a favor and raise them normally. Just put your foot down when they want to do super retarded shit, and they'll turn out okay. They will, I swear to you, they will. Just buy them video games, or put them into a sport or something. But if your autistic son comes to you and says, I believe I'm a wolf, maybe hit them with a belt? I don't know. Just, at the very least, say no. No, you are not a wolf. This discussion is over.
He sat and watched me redo a hard drive. Once. A couple of hours later, my wife walked in and reloaded all the data and whatever. And he redid the hard drive himself. That was the first time reality really hit me that, okay, we're not just older and don't remember how the other kids were. That was the first time I said, okay, he's going to be different.
In Buffalo lives a small community of Therians who run an amateur radio show. Steven is one of the hosts.
We're going to my workplace. It's a little computer repair shop, about 15 minutes away. All I do is I get in, fix computers, and interact with customers.
Steven is an IT technician and keeps his work and private life separate.
I don't really feel like I can be myself at work. I have to put on a very professional attitude and look.
Is that how you feel, or is that what your boss told you when you showed up dressed like a mascot? When you showed up into the Geek Squad at Best Buy dressed as a fucking neon green Puma, and your boss said, no, what the fuck are you doing? We fix computers here, stop it.
And if I do anything that involves Therian, it really breaks the professional side of things. It's very difficult for someone to be themselves and also continue that life. All of normal life is a very strange and abstract feeling. Everything is structured very differently compared to the wilderness.
Steven believes he is an African leopard and likes to go by his leopard name, which is Shroud. He has strong feline traits and likes to run and hunt.
This motherfucker's in the park hunting ducks. could you imagine you drop your laptop off to get it fixed? It's like running slow and shit. And this dude takes it from you. And an hour later, before you go to pick your laptop up, he's chasing ducks in the fucking park.
Climbing and running and stuff it's very natural. It's very instinctual. So when I'm climbing up a tree or something and I lay down on the branch, it's pretty close to what I remember.
His leopard side is based on a series of intense memories.
When I was little, I had a lot of smaller memories, usually of laying on a tree branch or sitting on a rock and looking out across the savanna. And this was before I even knew what the savanna was, before I'd even seen a photograph or a video. Externally, I am a human being. I have these hands and this body, but internally, I am a leopard. I have the mannerisms and the behaviors, the thoughts, and the memories of it.
I don't know many leopards that speak English so fluently, or dress themselves and wear prescription eyeglasses. I didn't know you had all those mannerisms down. This is remarkable. Leopards like to give TV interviews, do they? I'm learning so much, this is much better than National Geographic. Who needs those TV shows about wildlife when we've got Mr. Leopard here to teach us his culture?
An African leopard. I don't consider myself human at all, other than my body. I see my body as more of a vessel that doesn't match what I really have inside.
Stephen lives in Buffalo, where a small community of Therians have gathered. It is one of the reasons he moved here. Through the internet, he has met
Oh, hey, bing, bing, wahoo, bros. I'm not saying there's a correlation going on here, but autistic people that think they're werewolves and shit and Nintendo consoles seem to maybe go hand in hand. I mean, he ain't holding the fucking PlayStation controller. This dude ain't playing a 360. Just putting that out there.
Hundreds of people who believe that they are also animals. He now lives with one himself, Timothy, a raccoon.
That's my plushie net, stuffed animals, plushies. Various stuffed animals I've collected over the years. Some I've had since childhood, some I bought in the past few years.
Timothy is not just a raccoon. He is also Stephen's partner.
We've been together for 4 years.
Almost. Oh God, I'm being hugged. I've known you for 4 years. It hasn't been 4 years since we've been together yet.
Oh, it was wobbly voice white. Yeah, we all know leopards and raccoons get along so fucking well.
Well, yeah. Pretty close. Like
in February.
3 months away?
There's no raccoons in Africa. And I'd imagine that in the wild a raccoon might be prey.
No. We're backing that up for a second. They tried to subtly put that in and then act like it was nothing. No. Back that up. Where is it?
Away? There's no raccoons in Africa.
There we go. Do you notice they had to blur it out? Because the raccoon has a massive erection. The raccoon has a giant fucking boner. What the fuck? Nice. Very subtle documentary. Very subtle. This is normal. This is totally normal. This is what the suburbs in a normal American town are like. Nothing awkward about... Is that the Star of David? It's a cross. I'm sorry. That would have put me into overdrive on some jokes, but no. Let's see. Nintendo consoles, furries, and furry porn art, and portraits hung on the fucking wall. So when mom and dad come by for Thanksgiving, and they look over at the wall, they see a fucking raccoon with a 10-inch cock fully hard and throbbing as his gay leopard boyfriend embraces him.
And I'd imagine that in the wild, a raccoon might be prey.
Yeah, we get along just fine. There's no real like predator prey relationship or anything. We're just normal people when it comes to that.
Because while we do feel the pull of our Therian sides, and we are raccoon and leopard, ultimately we are still human. As much as we don't want to admit that half the time, we are still human. So we still whatever species we.
I don't know. That's a very good question. You know what? That's worth a poll. That is worth a poll. All right, chat. You need to answer this as asked by somebody watching the stream. Who is the top? I don't remember what their names are. I don't remember. Giant gay cat? Is he the top? Or is it... is it squinty-eyed... misspelled. Who cares? Squinty-eyed. I don't even know how to spell raccoon. There we go. Or is it big gay cat or squinty-eyed raccoon? Let's find out who the top is in this relationship. Just take a minute to drink it in. It really could go either way. He's got the lisp and the glasses. But this screams, I'm more comfortable wearing a dress. So I'm not sure which one's pitching and which one's catching. You take your guess, and we'll check in on the results in a few minutes.
I feel that we are identified with is not too relevant to whether or not we love each other.
Their dream is to one day create a commune for like-minded people. A safe haven where Therians can live and be together.
I'll text you. The normal ways of living are kind of constraining, and one of the influencing factors of leaving home is so I could be with people who share the same beliefs and culture as me. A lot of people who grow up in highly religious...
How much do you want to bet that this dude, and the purple our squinty-eyed raccoon, has masturbated at least a few thousand times to Guardians of the Galaxy? When that movie came out, that was like his... That's like his super special porn. I want you to just picture this dude furiously beating off as he loops Guardians of the Galaxy on his fucking television.
Areas are shunned or persecuted or just generally downright looked down upon because of their Therian side, and a lot of them end up fleeing toward better areas with good friends, and that's where they spend their lives.
I did feel alone before I found Therian communities. I never had very many friends growing up. I was always viewed as strange for various reasons, mannerisms, the way I talk even, people found to be weird. But finding a group of people who, in some way, society found strange, they're incredibly accepting people. And I felt immediately at home.
Oh, they should not be allowed near the zoo. All right, let's take a look at our poll. Who do I... You know, the giant gay cat is a little too feminine. Somebody said I should have had their both bottoms as a fucking option on the poll, which is probably true. I'm going to go with squinty-eyed raccoon. I bet he's got some rage issues. He's a little too soft-spoken. I bet he's violent when he's sexual. So I'm going to go with squinty-eyed raccoon. Let's see what the vote is. Okay. Well, the winner, giant gay cat. Congratulations, giant gay cat. You are the top in the relationship. And the raccoon is the bottom.
To further connect with his leopard side, Stephen likes spending time in the African section of the local zoo.
Beautiful animal, though.
See, now that I remember. That's very recognizable. It's because when they're on the savannah, they don't actually
hide.
Oh, he
spotted us.
I've been spotted.
Hi, kitty.
You know, I'm actually really curious now. We've read enough stories about zoophiliacs, all the weirdos that are into bestiality, otherkins, furries, all that shit. Has there ever been one of these guys that was brave enough to let a lion fuck him? Like, does that exist? Is there like a news article somewhere of a dude dying because he tried to get fucked by a lion? That has to have happened at least once. One of these idiots, horny and drunk, had to wander into a zoo, pull their pants off and jump into a lion cage, and try to tempt it into mounting him, only to be eaten. I need to look that up and see if that's happened, because I have a feeling at some point it has.
It's almost like knowing someone in a distant extended family. These gems back here, they were exactly as I remembered them in my memory. The memory of hunting and attacking one of them. It's very weird. It's like killing someone then meeting their family. It's almost awkward. I know it was a separate life or some separate...
What is that story? Man suffocated to death after having sex with an anaconda. Well, it's a good runner-up, but I want to hear about the guy that got eaten trying to fuck a lion.
Entity or separate connection or something, but it's still very awkward. The past life memories are very real.
All right, this actually might be it. Let me just pause this for a second. Let's see if this is actually a story about a furry getting murdered trying to fuck a lion. Man mauled to death by lions in front of busloads of zoo visitors. Victim ignored keepers and scaled 12-foot perimeter wall, jumped inside the lion enclosure. Let's just see if they've got a reason for why he did this. Give me a minute. Okay, man entered. Immediately spotted. They're very curious, of course. Okay, but there's nothing saying why he did it. We need it to be blatant. It has to be very blatant about why he's jumping into the lion enclosure instead of just being an insane asshole. Okay, I'll look into the rest of that later. We're nearing the end of our documentary, so we'll finish this up. There we go.
I mean, they're as real as all the other memories I have. It's almost unsettling to be here and look at them, but at the same time, it's yet another link, another connection to the inside, and another way to bring the memory back a bit.
The group in Buffalo don't just identify with being animals. They also dress up as...
You know, I'm not even going to... This story right here, I'm just going to say outright, I don't think it's bestiality. That's just Australian shit. I can picture an Aussie dude getting high off his mind on methamphetamines and deciding he's going to fuck a crocodile. I don't even think he's into bestiality. I think it was just one-upping his friends on a dare. You know, Ozzy, 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 oi, oi, oi. He's like, dude, I'm so fucking high on meth right now, I'm gonna fuck that crocodile. That's how I see that conversation going.
Then.
Some wear tails and collars, and others wear entire fursuits. It is a subculture within the community called furry. Every month, they meet up to express their animal sides.
It's kind of about taking everything that like Therians might be into, except furries are more social with it. So we kind of connect more and we hang out and we do fun things. And we act like crazy and we make other people laugh.
There's a lot of similarities between furry and Therian. It's all about anthropomorphics, which is anything between human and animal. I usually just wear my collar and my tail and sometimes my ears. I just let myself go, let myself be free, and I fit in with the community perfect.
Outside of the community, not everyone is as understanding.
Yeah, we get a lot of strange looks. We're just kind of bizarre and eccentric. Some people want us to stay away because we're different. Some people love our antics, find us hilarious and really cute.
The negative perception is that they just leave us alone and walk away. The positive perception is that they want to know more about it. There's really nobody who directly says anything negative. There's just people who can't. You can tell that they just don't like it. They can't handle us, so they move.
God, it would have been so amazing if some dad, like four lanes down away from him, just started throwing bowling pins at his head. Just get the fuck out of here. Get away from my kids.
Away.
In Brunswick, Georgia, Matthew has been waiting for his 18th birthday to fulfill one major wish. It is something that would make him feel truly like an animal.
I haven't liked my name since I was in elementary school, and the reason being, I've just never liked the way it sounded. It wasn't even an identity thing back then, it was just I didn't like how it sounded to my ears. And I've always wanted to change it. I've always been called some sort of nickname throughout school.
Now that Matthew is 18, he has the right to change his name to his wolf name.
This is my signature, well, the one I use whenever I can. When I change my name, I'm going to use it everywhere. That's my paw print, and that says Shiro Wolf right under it.
Okay, Prince. Real fancy. Oh, what does that say? That's my paw print name. It's not pronounced as anything. It's just a special symbol that I'm going to make you try to pronounce to annoy you. Gotcha.
Actually, a mix between Japanese and Norwegian, and it means white wolf.
Despite Matthew's determination, his parents are less enthusiastic. They are concerned it could hold him back.
His fucking ringtone isn't a woo. This guy has a clock that a woos and his phone a woos. Everything in his house is set to fucking screech like a wolf. Oh, I bet the parents drink a lot. I bet they drink so much.
Well, he may have a scholarship to Georgia Tech. I'm hoping that changing his name doesn't affect that at all. And I've explained this to him, but, you know, he's an adult. He can do this without our permission. So it's a battle I can't fight anymore.
You sure you want to do that?
Yeah.
Better be thinking ahead because you're going to need...
Okay, this is passive parenting. Neither of them think it's a good idea, but they're too scared to put their foot down. This is why your son is doing stupid shit. Don't ask him if it's a bad idea when you think it's a bad idea. Tell him it's a bad idea. It will have negative consequences for the rest of his life. They're like, oh, maybe they're hem and hawing. They can't just be, you know, outright with it. Like, hey, we're your parents. We love you. But you are acting like a massive retard right now. And this is a very bad decision you're embarking upon. But no, it's a maybe kind of, maybe. I love my baby boy. Does my baby boy want to use a paw print? You know, grow a spine. Fuck.
You have a birth certificate. If that name is going on your college application, you're going to have the birth certificate match it. You're going to have to send off for one.
I honestly hate that he wants to change his name. He's been talking about this for years.
Yeah, I filled in my forms for my name change.
Saying, so do you have a middle name?
Yeah.
What?
Themian.
She nearly choked on her fucking food. She, look, dad looks right at her. What's your name? It's Shiro Thamian. Awoo! That's my name, Mom. Oh, she wants to stab him with her fork. Look at that look. She choked on her broccoli.
Thamian?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Believe it or not, it doesn't mean anything. It's literally a name that came to me. Like in my head.
The name sounds so strange. You know, White Fang was a better name to me because at least it was something I heard of, which was a wolf story when I was a kid.
And it's really straightforward, unless you're... It even says on all the legal sites, unless you're changing your name to a number or something obscene, they never get rejected.
He asked, you know, would I be okay with him changing his name? And I said, you know, I can't stop you. I guess I can live with it, but no, I don't like it.
That's what I'm talking about. Weak-willed parenting. You need to be the authority. You're not their fucking friend, you're their parent. Act like a parent. You can love your kids and be nice to them, but Jesus, grow a fucking spine. Kids coming to you for guidance and you're gonna let them do this retarded shit? Are you out of your mind?
Today is a defining moment for Matthew.
I'm feeling excited, you know. I'm finally doing this, we're here. You know, it's very exciting. It means I'm a wolf, officially.
Despite his parents' worries, he is adamant that this is the right thing for him.
Yes, I finally got it done. I have my forms right here that I need to bring to the newspaper, and everything else is done.
In order to make the process legal, Matthew must finally submit a request to the local paper.
You remember, like, well, maybe this is before a lot of your time, but back when they used to do TV serials that people actually watched, you know, 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s, there was like a common theme that would always pop up when it came to kids wanting to do stupid shit, which was you'd let them do it, but you'd push it so far they'd never want to do it again. One of the classic examples, you catch your kid smoking, you sit their ass down and you make them smoke like 5 packs in a row till they get so sick they don't ever want to smoke again. Because it's a bad experience. Maybe the approach to something like this is, your kid comes to you and says, I think I'm a wolf. I have a wolf spirit in me. You say, okay, I think you're a wolf too. Then you drive them out into the woods, take all their possessions, and say, I'll come back for you in 3 weeks. You live with your wolf brothers. You don't need us. You're a wolf now. You hunt and scavenge and do wolf things. I believe in you, son. And when you come back 3 years later, 3 weeks later, they're sobbing under a tree, cold and hungry, and they've realized they are in fact not a wolf.
Hi, how are you? I'm submitting the form to change my name from Matthew Schimmel to Shiro Wolf.
Yeah, see if you like.
Okay.
I truly believe that names have a lot of effect on things, even though you try not to be. You get preconceived ideas.
Well, yeah, you could, if the kid doesn't pick up on it right away, you can leave him out there for 3 years. He'll survive. He's a wolf after all.
You know, you hear some names and you think, oh, must be kind of nerdy. But then you hear Shiro and you think, what is that? I mean, you know, you can't even put like a nationality or anything with that to me.
Shiro is S-H-I-R-O.
Yes.
I told him I'd be okay with it, but it really bothers me. But the ultimate goal is his happiness.
He fucking barked. He barked after the name change.
It really bothers me. But the ultimate goal is his happiness.
In Buffalo, New York, live a small community of people who believe that in some way, they are an animal. They live together, hang out together, and have formed close relationships with each other. Caleb, Stephen, and Timothy have fully immersed themselves within this community, and their relationship together is not conventional.
When I first met these guys, me and Shroud really hit it off, and we had a connection, and we were never limited in that connection because you were so graceful and just everybody being together. And then we kind of ended up realizing that all three of us is what really made the environment. And when it was just me and him, it wasn't really, you know, as fun to be around each other.
They are in an open, polyamorous relationship.
Oh, we found the top. That's why it didn't make sense. They were both bottoms. Holy shit, Chet, you were actually 100% correct. They're in an open, polyamorous relationship. The wolf is literally the alpha fucking the two bottoms.
Meaning that they can have multiple partners, whilst also being together.
I've never really been the monogamous type. I've been in monogamous relationships before, but each and every one of them was destroyed by jealousy. Stupid, petty jealousy. And then I got into a relationship that was more open. On my then boyfriend's side, he was very open, very, very polyamorous, and he pried it out of me. And the more and more he showed me it, the more and more I realized, like, oh, I don't have to be jealous, because there's nothing here to be jealous about.
It's something that works for us. It's not something that works for everybody. There's no way it ever will.
Look at that smile on his face. I suppose in the land of the retards, he is king. All right, this is the alpha wolf fucking the gayest raccoon and the gayest leopard he could find. Look at him standing, legs spread apart, hucking stones, showing his dominance. He's banging them both.
Exactly. It's just something that solved the problem for us. And we've worked with it for years.
As far as how it developed between us, it's just obviously we shared similar viewpoints, similar spirituality, similar philosophies on life. And we just kind of meshed. And since we weren't limiting ourselves, since I wasn't saying, Shroud's mine, you can't have him, it just kind of developed. Just like any other relationship. If anything, I think it's just a pile of people having sex. No, there's love, damn it. If sex happens, it happens, but there's...
You're correct, Chad. He has a harem, or in this circumstance, a hairy harem, because they're all filthy animals. He's got a whole group of them. Drives them around in the fuck bus. It's the alpha wolf driving the fuck bus full of retards, all dressed up like different animals. What flavor of the week is it going to be today? The raccoon? The sea lion? I don't know. I'm going to fuck them all.
Love. We can be with other people. We have other relationships. We have other partners. It can get complex. It can be simple. It can be whatever.
But I guess what the idea behind our relationship especially is no matter what culture will say a relationship is or isn't, or how it should or shouldn't be, what's acceptable or what's not, we don't care. As long as we are happy with each other, that's all that matters.
We just do our own thing.
I see in the furry community, they boast about, you know, having the polyamorous, but it really ends up being a lot more complicated than they think, and there's been a lot of hurt. I've seen Caleb in relationships and out of relationships, and I see them struggle with it, and there's a lot of drama to it because they're young people, but I don't say anything because they believe that this is okay.
Yep, again, have you noticed the common factor with all the parents? I don't say anything. I think this is bad. I think this is mental illness. I think this is a mistake, but I don't say anything. That's why these people are on a documentary today, because the parents didn't fucking say anything when they had the chance. She knows her son is insane, but she's not going to say it because it's uncomfortable. They want them to be happy. They don't want them to survive or be successful or be independent. They want their happiness first. Which in their minds means, I don't say anything when my child does degenerate, stupid shit.
Okay. But I think they're going to find out on their own that things can become very, very complicated.
Wolf couple Ben and Kimberly live on a farm in West Sussex in England. They live with Ben's mom, Sue, who is only now discovering about the couple's animal side.
I mean, obviously, this is all very new to me, but, I mean, so when did you start having these feelings? As early as Kim, or later, or earlier?
Thinking about it, probably a little bit early, before Kim, but not really realising it, what it was at the time. I just kind of pushed it all back and forgot about it.
What did you think it was? I mean, what...
I had absolutely no idea, and I'd...
your brain doesn't really kind of comprehend things like that. It just ignores it and kind of copes with it.
Mm.
But then when I was around Kim, she was doing, you know, much the same things. I thought, oh, well, you know, that must have been something.
Yeah.
And then those feelings start cropping up again.
Not strong,
then kind of becomes very evident that there's a reason for it, as opposed to, you know, you're just going crazy.
If I had those feelings, you see, it wouldn't say to me that somebody else was driving me. What makes you think it is this inner spirit within you?
I can hear it, I can feel it, and I just know it's there. It's like, it's...
Do you see it?
It's faith.
Do you see it? Well, yeah.
You talk about faith.
I mean, I have faith, but I don't.
Are we going to finally see a parent try to put their foot down a little bit? I get the feeling this particular mother maybe didn't know how crazy they were, right? And started finding out when the documentary film crew showed up and told them what the documentary was about. And now she's trying to gauge if her son is actually insane. Do you see the wolf spirit, son? Does it talk to you in your mind? Does it tell you to hurt yourself?
Don't ever feel that I have somebody speaking to me. But you are convinced that it is a spirit, and a spirit within you, as opposed to just you having these feelings.
Well, it's exactly the same, just I don't voice it as much as everyone else does.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just trying to understand it, sweet, that's all. Yeah.
It's a very difficult thing to try and explain. You've just got to take it on good faith, really.
Yeah, I'm not saying you're a liar. I'm just trying to understand it, really, you know.
Mm.
Or, you know, it's not an easy thing to understand,
no.
Obviously.
Oh.
Look at her. You can tell from the body language. She found out her son thinks he's a wolf and his girlfriend's a wolf. And now she's trying to very subtly pull the cat away from them. Look at her guarding it with her body. She knows what's up. It's starting to, you know, the numbers are starting to compute in her head. 2 + 2 = 4. Your son is fucking the cat.
It's weird, though, because it's so normal for us now.
Well, yeah. Obviously, a lot of people would not think you were normal.
Oh, yeah, but...
I'm not saying all of my friends, but a lot of my cattle friends would think that completely bizarre. And they wouldn't even look any further than, you know, that the pair of them would need help.
For many Therians and other kin, believing something that nobody else can see creates its own unique problems.
It's very annoying that other people can't see how I feel, not just on a Therian level, in general. I think and feel so differently from most people and they don't really understand it.
Finding the community, I think, was the first time I ever had friends who were like me, people who wanted to do the same things as me, people who wanted to communicate the same way as me, people who were just interested in the same facets of life.
It's not something that we choose, it's something that you're born with, essentially. You discover.
I get the feeling, this is what I've noticed with a lot of these weird groups, is I think it's, there are a lot of crazy people, don't get me wrong, but I think it's a lot of really lonely fucking people that have a connection to nobody, right? No real-life friends, no internet friends. They have no outlet, no other human being that will give them the time of day. And so they latch on to crazy shit like this just to feel a part of it. And I think deep down in their soul, deep, deep down inside, they know it's insane, they know it's bullshit, but they can't not believe in it because it's the only thing that lets them interact with other human beings. I think it's like this for furries and other kin. I think you see that a lot with, like, the transgender shit that's really popular right now. Like, I've noticed that behavior with a lot of them.
As you get older, it's something that you discover that it's a part of yourself.
I feel very different. I feel extremely different. I feel like I just don't belong with the crowd.
I don't know how to explain how I feel. I know I'm different, and I'm making no attempt to change it. I mean, a lot of people are different, but, you know, I just like who I am, you know.
Yes, I'd say yes, it is like a cult.
You know, I can be proud of my identity rather than ashamed of it.
Well, there you go. I hope you've enjoyed our journey into insanity with the Therians, the Otherkins, and their amazing transformations into all the animals they think they really truly are deep, deep down inside, which they aren't, by the way. There's no animals out there that use computers and wear eyeglasses and eat with a fork and a knife, speak English fully. I think maybe we need shock therapy for this. Maybe we need to just drive them out to the woods and let them see what it's like to be the animal they think they are, so they can realize they aren't actually that animal. Maybe that's what's needed to fix this. It's like those camps for kids that misbehave and they drive them into the desert and leave them out there for like a month. That kind of shit. Maybe that's the solution. Who knows? And of course, Florida Man. Why would it not start with that title? If something fucking insane is happening, Florida has to be in that title somewhere. So we'll start with the Florida Foray. I read through chat. I think that edged out the other choices. So let's do this. Will this show up? There we go. It's up on Fox News. Somebody sent this to me like 2 or 3 days ago. I had a nice chuckle reading it. Florida man accused of killing two, eating man's face, believed he was half dog, half man, doctors say. Oh, well, it's good the doctors have could. I love the... If there's ever been a face that said, I have made some mistakes in my life, I think that might be the face right there. That's a face you get after the methamphetamines leave your system. Once the crack high has completely left you, and the sober reality of what you've done hits, that's the face you make. That's the face you make when you wake up after a frat party and a fat fucking woman is lying next to you naked and she's got syrup all over her tits and you're like, what the fuck did I do last night? How am I going to explain this one away? A former college student accused of fatally attacking a husband and wife in their Florida home and gnawing the man's face off believed he was a half dog, half man, a forensic psychologist said in a mental health report. Austin Heruff, 22, has been charged with killing John Stevens, 59, and his wife, Michelle Mission, at their home in Martin County on August 15, 2016. Wait a minute. That's a little... How old is this fucking story? Oh, I've been bamboozled. I thought this was new. Well, you know, whatever. Fuck it. It's a man eating another person. The fact that Mr. Hanoff persisted in biting the male victim in the presence of police officers, in spite of being shot, being tased, and receiving multiple kicks to the head, suggests that he was actively psychotic. Do you think? Was that, gave you an inkling something might have been? What was the name of that fucking Russian guy that they, they hung him, they shot him, they tried to chop his fucking head off? Rasputin? He's like an American Rasputin. Oh, I love that, the officer quote. Yeah, we thought something might be up with him, you know, because we shot him and tased him and kicked him in his fucking head, but he wouldn't stop biting people. He kept screaming about being a twin spirit and his otherkin fucking headmates. You know, when I put that hollow point in his fucking forehead, I thought he'd go down, but it was like a horror movie. He just pissed on my leg to show dominance and went back to eating these people. Resnick wrote in a 38-page report, well, you'd imagine it would be a long one. It was unlikely that it was a drug-induced psychosis. It was unlikely that it was a drug-induced psychosis that led to the attacks. Now, perfectly sane, didn't touch anything. Investigators believed Haroff may have been on the synthetic drug, but a toxicology report by the FBI found no designer drugs in his system. Only trace amounts of marijuana. The report cited a statement by his attorney in which he said evaluation confirms Austin could not form the requisite intent to commit these crimes due to his severe mental illness. Oh, you know, you think if we look into him a little bit, we're going to find like a DeviantArt account? All they found in his system was marijuana. How much marijuana did you inject? Austin, tell us. How many hits of the dopey drug did you use? How many shots were you putting in with the needle? We need to know. It's important. We need to save other children. He's been charged with 2 counts of first-degree murder with a weapon. Wait, he killed them? I'm sorry. I thought it said just attack. I'm not even paying attention. Oh, killing two. See, it's one of the, when you have a headline like this, the part about killing people doesn't even pop out at you. It's the eating a man's face, half dog, half man thing. That's what got my attention. And then Florida. Those three things, not even paying attention to killing. I thought he just ate them, but he literally killed them. Could you imagine being the cop that walked into that shit? I don't think any amount of training is going to prepare you for it. You walk into a fucking house and a dude is on all fours, naked as the day he was born, eating a woman's face and barking. And he's wiggling his ass. He's like a, what was that fucking YouTuber, Austin Jones, he's twerking like that. Like he's got a tail, a non-existent tail up in the air. He's so very happy. And you shoot the motherfucker and he just keeps eating them. So you walk over and you start to kick him in his fucking skull like a scene out of American History X. Bite the curb, motherfucker. And he still won't stop. And you gotta write a report for that shit. Yeah, well, he smoked a little dope. I think that might have been what did it to him. Holy fucking shit. I'm gonna take a second here. I've gotta look up his name. I have to see if this man has a fucking DeviantArt account. Why wouldn't he? Why wouldn't this perfect individual have a DeviantArt account? Facing murder charges? Well, I mean, this is so old. We should find out what happened. CBS News has something from just this year. Okay, so. Wait, he killed a couple. It's an old murder that they're talking about now for some reason. Okay, maybe it is a recent story. What? How the f- Okay, I have to show this. Somebody fucking explain this one to me. Oh, that's not what I wanted you to do. Okay, there we go. Somebody explain this to me. Haroff's attorneys are preparing an insanity plea, obviously. In a 2017 interview with Dr. Phil, he said he never planned to do it. He didn't want to do it. Haroff's hospital bed interview with Dr. Phil couldn't explain the attack. I don't know. If I did, I'd tell you. How the fuck does a dude that was shot and beaten by police and still wouldn't stop eating people, who thought he was a dog and ripped people's faces off with his fucking teeth, how is he getting an interview with Dr. Phil? How is Dr. Phil swinging this shit? Like, what? Who in the insanity ward do you need to bribe with money to get an interview with this psychotic fuck? That is really stunning. I wonder if there's video of it. I mean, we could almost go watch the video. I don't know if it'd be any good or not. I just was a little awestruck by the fact Dr. Phil interviewed the Florida man that eats people. And they just, in the article, they're so casual about it. Yeah, Phil talked to him. It's not a big deal. Yeah, just decided to say, how do you do? How do you do? I'm Dr. Phil. I hear you like to eat people. Oh, you don't? You don't remember? Didn't mean to do it? Okay, well, I believe you, buddy. You're a good pupper. Come here, let Dr. Phil pet you. Don't bite me. I'll pet you. You want a dog treat? Maybe that's how he got the interview. He gave him some nice kibbles and bits and shit, and this guy just rolled over on his back, laying there, getting petted on his stomach by Dr. Phil for his fucking interview about killing two people. Holy shit. Dr. Phil will copyright strike you. Yeah, he probably would. I'm pretty sure Dick Masterson... Let me light a cigarette here. Ah, there we go. Gotta love that cancer. Pretty sure Dick Masterson was on the show, and I think he ran into trouble trying to re-upload clips of it, even though he was getting fucking interviewed. I would imagine Dr. Phil is kind of a cunt, or at least the parent company of Dr. Phil is kind of a cunt about copywriting things. Ugh, I love it. Any story that starts with the fucking title Florida Man, you know you're in for a treat. But that wasn't the only one. There was another one, too. Let me see if I can find this. This one's a bit older. But as I was reading this, I seem to vaguely remember a story about a triple furry homicide. So let's go read that one. Oh, Rolling Stone. Oh, do I... You know, fuck it. It's just... we'll find pictures of them in a minute. You know what? I want the pictures. I want you to see what these people look like, because it really... It really helps to make it pop. Okay. I think we're good. Let's do this. Just following up on it. I don't think they're from Florida. No, California, of course. California, why not? Good second runner-up. Close runner-up. Florida for crazy shit happening in their fucking state. All right, here we go. On September 24th, police arrived in Fullerton, California home to find two children, 6 and 9, waiting for them on the porch in terror. Inside the bodies of the girls' parents, along with a family friend, lay dead. Jennifer Goodwill Yost, 39, her husband, Christopher Yost, 34, and their friend, Arthur, quote-unquote, Billy Botcher, 28, had all been killed inside the house. Jennifer Yost's 17-year-old daughter, Caitlin, was reported missing. 3 days after the deaths, police arrested 21-year-old Joshua Acosta and 25-year-old Frank Felix. Caitlin, who had been friends with the Acostas until recently, when her family made her break off contact with the older men, was recovered safely by the police. But that's not the part that's interesting. The story soon attracted national attention after it was revealed that Jennifer and Caitlin were part of a Southern California furry subculture, dedicated fans of anthropomorphized animals who typically flock to cartoons and fan fiction depicting adorable animals that walk on 2 feet. Clearly, whoever wrote this has not seen the pictures that they depict. As were the two men arrested for the murder. Now, despite no reported evidence that their joint interest in the fur community was a motive for the murders, the incident is causing concern among furries, already sick of defending the scene from negative stereotypes. God, you have to love the furry community. It's a triple fucking homicide. Two dudes that wanted to bang the 17-year-old chick, but mommy and daddy said no, show up in their fucking fur fag outfits, and kill the whole fucking house. And the furry community is worried it'll look bad for them. No condolences for the dead parents or the distraught daughter. Just, hey man, you know, when you print this, try to go easy on us, all right? Not all furries, bro. Not all furries commit triple homicides to tap some teenage ass. I think it really is the worst that ever happened with ties to this community. Blogger Patch O'Fur wrote on the furry news site Dog Patch Press, referring to the Fullerton murders. It's not that unusual compared to other crimes that happen in cities, but I think it's disproportionately big to a niche group. We are devastated and very angry, Melinda Gale said as she pissed on the carpet. A friend of the Yost and a member of the fur community told the Orange County Register, "It's a really bad situation. We're canceling events out of respect to mourn and a lot of outside negativity. That's not what we're about. We're very fun-loving. It's not a lifestyle that's deviant." Has there ever been a bigger lie ever printed in a newspaper? We are very fun-loving. It's not a lifestyle that is deviant. Listen, you got the wrong idea, all right? Just because these two older men wanted to fuck that underage girl and so killed their whole family to do it doesn't mean we're deviant and fucked up, all right? Fur fags, we're pretty moral people, all right? We ask the dog if it consents first. When we go to a farm and we find a stallion that we like, you know, that neighs at us in that kinky sort of way that stallions do, we ask for one clop for yes and two clops for no. We are not deviants. Because a subset of furry culture sexualizes anthropomorphized animals, the entire fur fandom is sometimes equated with fetishism. The truth is, in fact, much more innocent. Who wrote this? Oh, I need a name. How much do you want to bet the motherfucker that wrote this is a furry? Mary Emily O'Hara? I know your fucking secret. Putting all these little soft words in here. I know what you're doing, couching all these sentences. Some furries dress in fursonas. In online forums, some fans expressed fears that the murder links to the community could represent the fandom negatively. Some questioned why this aspect of their lives needed to be mentioned at all. One Reddit user, of course, snarkily commented, "Great. Now CSI might do something with furries again," referring to the CBS Procedural's 2003 episode, Fur and Loathing. And these would be our two fine furry gentlemen. Ugh. I vaguely remember this story when it happened. I know there's more to it. I wish I had done a little more research, but I'm so incredibly lazy. Fucking furries, man. We're not deviant. Trust O'Hara. She's got no reason to lie to you. Okay? That's the Rolling Stone. Why would the Rolling Stone lie to innocent people? All right, we're not bad. We're not bad people that fuck farm animals and molest children and draw really horrific shit and apparently commit triple homicides. We're not bad. We're not deviant. It's you that's fucked up. You're the problem, society, for judging us. Why don't you look into a mirror, man? Why don't you look into a mirror and see that you're the problem, okay? Not me dressing up in this mop so I look like a shaggy dog. Holy fuck. Ugh.